Okay, so let's do the Mantisse. Let's do the Mantisse. The Mantisse is a nice ship. It's a nice one. It's a powerful ship. It does have a lot of some problems with ships early on. There are certain ships that it does have problems with. Like I said, just repeating myself, but yeah, let's go ahead and let's go some Mantisse shenanigans running. Tell Microsoft you're switching to Apple products if Bill Gates and Steve Ballmer don't follow you on Twitter. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, excuse me, they gotta fucking retweet me every single day for the next year. Red Rocket. What did I name this ship last time? Let me take a look. What's up, MSD or M60? How are you doing, man? Did I name it Communism? Yeah, Bob Ross. Oh, what's the red color that he uses? Is it Indian red? There we go. All right, now let's get the crew named. Celev. Alrighty, very nice. M60. TSK. Stir fry. Okay. And tomato gets to be the NG. Okie dokie. Now. New Twitch emote. Is that a new Twitch emote? Is that a mad? It looks like a Mad TV emote. A party time one. Alright, so. Honor to serve. Alright, well, you might not be honored when you go down to critical amounts of health and almost die. But for now. Okay, sounds good. Okay, so here's what we're doing here. We're running the Mantisse. Alright. And the Mantisse is a powerful ship. Obviously, you get a two-man teleporter, standard stuff. You get two Mantis to start with on this particular ship. And also, you don't have sensors on this ship, which is also pretty, which is pretty relevant as far as, you know, you can't see what's on the ship that you're boarding. You have to know, or at least have a good idea of what you're going to be up against. And you can tell a lot of that based on what the enemy ships have. Or what the enemy ship's name is. If it's a rock type ship, but it's a pirate ship, it's going to have not necessarily rock crew on it and stuff like that. So, and then that also means that you could be boarding a rock type pirate ship and it just has Mantis on it, which can be a serious problem when you're only boarding with Mantis. But anyway, so the ship starts with a small bomb and a basic laser, and it only has the weapons capability of having one of them on at the same time. Only one of the two, so you only get one weapon's power. So obviously that's kind of an issue at some times, but for the most part it's not too big of a deal. I mean, if you have to fight a drone ship, your method of killing it is firing the small bomb into their shields, and then you have to use the basic laser to actually do damage to their ship, which is really slow. And if they have a powerful weapon set up, you're going to have huge problems. You can't send your guys over with a level 1 teleporter. And I would not recommend even sending them over with a level 2 teleporter, because if your teleporter takes 2 points of damage and they have a powerful setup, then you're going to fucking lose 2 crew, and then you're pretty much going to be struggle bugging through the rest of the run. So anyway, alright, let's see this. So we do start with Mantis Pheromones, which is a very powerful augment when you're using a two-man teleporter. And the reason is Mantis already moves faster than any other race in the game, and the 25% increase is just that much faster. So what that means is you can move your crew into positions, into rooms, before the enemy can. So you can move to a room, get your guys in position and ready to fight, and the other guys are still like, oh, we're coming into the room now, and you guys, your Mantis can get hits on them before they're even ready to fight. So it's very powerful, And it's a very, and I'll show you a little bit more about that. So we'll get into the game, and I'll go over just a super little kind of like basically something that I do for anybody that asks how like crew works, how to like reposition them, because the ship does start with four crews, so we'll be able to show it really easily here. Okay, so let's start the run here. Right. Okay, so let's get all of our crew into one room here. Now, usually, the way that it works is when you move your first guy into the room, the order in which they enter the room is the top left first, and then the right, and then the bottom left, and then the right. Okay, so we're going to be entering. So when we move this Engie into the room, he's going to be moving into the top left, and we can pause, and he doesn't even have to move to the room. We can just see he's going to be taking up the space. Boom, right there in the top left. Doesn't matter where we click inside of this room. And if we take this Mantis here in the bottom left, we click him into the room. Even if we're in the bottom left, he goes to the top right, right? So this is order is always the case, unless, I'll show you the only exception to this. So they move into the room, we unpause and move them into the room. What I can show you, what I'll show you first is, so when this is the case, like if you just move your whole party into the room, they don't necessarily stay in the same order that they are. Like it seems like they have like kind of a default order in some fashion, so like they'll stay in this order. The NG is always going to be coming in last here. I don't know why. There's some kind of reason for it, I'm sure. I just don't know what it is. What's up, Epic Seal? So if let's say that this Mantis is really low on health and he's fighting a Mantis that's in that spot, right? He's fighting a Mantis that's in this top left corner, and we don't want him to be fighting that anymore because we don't want him to die. So here's what we do. We pause the game. Now we want to move this guy out of the room, and we don't actually want him to move out of the room. Like, we don't want to unpause and have him move out of the room. That's not what we want. What we want to do is we want to pause, we want to move him out of the room, and we'll take whoever we want to be taking his position, right? We want the, let's say we want the Angie to take his position, so we'll move him out of the room too. And then, so now, whoever we put in the room first, put back in the room, I mean, he's going to be back in that, he's going to go in that same default order. So we'll put him in the room, and so you can see he's filling up that slot. And the Mantis, he's still moving out of the room, but we want him to help out killing the guy too. But if there's no enemy in the top right spot of the room, then we move him back into the room, we unpause, and they change places. So, and you can do this with any combination, and typically, the easiest way to do it is, like one thing to note is that if I were to pause and let's, like, move our guys to a two-slot room, obviously four guys can't fit in a two-slot room, so we unpause, it takes two guys out of that room, right? So that ain't what we want. So sometimes if you're not paying attention, you could be like, okay, I gotta run my guys out of the room, and then suddenly these two guys are still getting their ass kicked by enemies, and you're like, oh shit, there goes my crew. So you gotta be very careful as far as that stuff goes. Now, if we wanted to change everybody's position, you know, we could do that just as easily. We move everybody out of the room, just use a four-slot room. Or you could use two-slot rooms, it doesn't really matter. And then the idea is, so it's going to be ordering from the left to the right, top first, and then the bottom second. So then, okay, so let's move this guy in the bottom left, let's move the Angie to the right here, and let's move this Mantis in the left and this Mantis to the right. So they don't exit the room and go to those other rooms, they stay right in the same room they are. We unpause, bam. Alright, very nice. So the only time when this does not apply is, let me show you. So the time when this does not apply is if there is a system that the crew can man, then they will move to that computer terminal first. So in this, let's take a look in this room. Now in this room there is a computer console for the engines, and that is in the top right corner. So now when I move this NG into the engines room, he's not going to go on the top left, he's going to go on the top right, because that's where that little computer console is. Doesn't matter where we click in the room, right? We just right click and he moves to that console first. Otherwise, you know, we enter the guys into the room, they're going to go same left, and then that right spot's filled, so then he goes bottom left and then right again afterwards. And the same is true is regardless of what position the terminal is, you can see the computer's there. And then in shields, I think it might be in the top left. It is. So he goes into the top left because that's where the computer is. And then, yeah. That's the basics of boarding. And I think the computer terminal might be on the right in this room. There it is. See? He goes into the right in that room, and he mans the system there. So hopefully that is a useful this is a useful tutorial, kind of a little tips and tricks kind of a thing for boarding. As far as actual boarding goes, you know, we'll go through the run and stuff like that. But this is just like a nice little, just kind of shows you the basic mechanics when you enter guys into rooms. This is the position that they take, unless there is a console in the room, in which case they go to that console first. And the only other thing to note is that enemies, that applies to enemies as well. Enemies will move into a room, and they will go, if they can man the console, then they will man that system, right? If they can't, if they're on your ship, they can't man your console, so they will go in the top left first, and then the right, etc., etc. So, right. So let's call that good, and then we'll continue with the run, okay? Let's rock and roll. Alright, so we're gonna get you guys in the teleporter, we're gonna get this NG in the engine, or this Mantis in the engines, the NG in the piling, and we're gonna save those positions. Very nice. Alright. Now, it's pretty important to actually have your guys manning, in the teleporter and ready to go right off the bat for a fight, because sometimes the difference, sometimes you don't want to board an enemy. Maybe it's a drone ship. You don't want to board them, but you want to have your guys in the teleporter right away, because sometimes they have a pretty powerful weapon setup, and they might only have like 2 crew or 3 crew or something like that. And you want to have your guys in the teleporter and ready to go, so that way you can kill their crew as fast as possible and make sure that you're taking as few shots to your ship as possible, because that's pretty important, right? You want to maintain as much ship health as possible. Hopefully we can do some good work here, Commando. If you have any questions, just shoot them at me and I'll do my best to answer them. And this is kind of what this, the whole thing is what this is about, is just taking our time, making sure we explain everything in great detail, and make sure that things are really nice and good to understand for everybody. So, all right, so let's get rocking and rolling here. Let's take our first jump, and we got a store here, which we don't want to be jumping to first. We don't have any scrap. We're not jumping to the store with zero scrap. We can't fucking buy anything, so I really don't like it when people complain to me, "Oh man, Billy, I jumped to the store, and I couldn't buy Burst Laser 2. How much scrap did you have? 79. You didn't have anything to sell? No. Why did you go to the fucking store? Like, if you go to a store and you don't have enough scrap to buy something that you really, really need, then you shouldn't go to the store. If you should hit as many jumps as you can. And I'm not saying that like every single time you can always hit a whole crap load of jumps beforehand, but most of the time you can. So just try and take your time. We're gonna at least hit these 3 jumps here, here, and here before even thinking about going to the store. And if we go to these 3 jumps and we make 0 scrap, we're not going to the store. The Mantis Pheromones, I know, sells for 25 scrap. This sells for 22 scrap, I think. And this sells for 10. So we're not going to be able to really buy much of anything, even if we sold all of that stuff. So we're going to be continuing on here. So let's avoid that store for now. We'll see if we can't make some money. FTL Knowledge, starring Craft Briller. That's right. All right. So this ship, they can provide some services. They're like a mercenary ship. So, we are not interested in hiring them for either of these things. Now, let's take a look at their ship setup here. This is a pretty difficult ship. Sometimes it is correct to hire these guys for their services. If you wanted to delay the rebels, it delays them by 2 jumps. If you hire them to scout the sector, like this is our first jump, so maybe if this was in sector 2 or 3 and we found these guys, maybe 11 scrap, but that could very well be worth paying 11 scrap for that. So we are gonna fight the ship here, I think, but this is a difficult little ship. So let's take a look. They have a heavy laser 1. Now that fires a 2-damage shot at 9 seconds, but it can't get through our 1-level shield. Now they do have a missile weapon that can pierce our shield. That's a problem, right? We don't like dealing with that. But we're gonna have to. So that's definitely an issue. Like, if that hits our shields, that's a huge problem. And even though we can't see inside of their ship because we haven't started the fight yet, some ships you can beforehand, some ships you can't. We can see exactly what they have as far as systems goes. We look in their system line down here. We see weapons, oxygen, shields, engines, weapons, piloting. Sorry, piloting, oxygen, shields, engines, weapons, and they have drone control. We don't know what kind of drones they got. They could have a combat drone. They could have a beam drone. They could have a ship repair drone. They could have an anti-boarding drone. They could have a drone on their ship that's just going to fight our guys, and that's a huge problem. And they also have hacking. And hacking is definitely a serious wild card here, because they could hack a system that doesn't matter. They could hack our piloting or our engines, which wouldn't be too bad. Our doors wouldn't be too bad either. Our teleporter would be annoying, because every time they activate it, they, boom, bring our guys back to our ship. That's very annoying. And oxygen would be fine as well. Medbay wouldn't really be a problem either. But if they hack our shields, like, that's a pretty big problem, because our shields could be down when that heavy laser fires at us, and we're going to cry if that happens. So we're going to fight the ship here. This could be a pretty darn difficult one. And to be honest, it is a potential run-under ship that we're going to be fighting here. But we're going to give it a shot, and we're going to see what we can't do. Now, we are going to be having the small bomb active here, because this is a really great support weapon. It'll bypass their shields. We can shut down a system. Probably going to be their weapons, unless their drones are really nasty. We're taking our time, Epic. You got to calm down, man. This is the whole run. This is what we do, brother. All right? All right, so I can assume there's probably going to be three guys. Their order of manning systems is going to be piloting, engines, and weapons. That's the way that it usually goes. Now, I'm going to just teleport into their weapons, and then we're going to see what they got. Okay, they have an anti-ship drone, or an anti-drone drone. So they have a rock guy, so we know they have three crew on their ship. So that's pretty annoying. Okay, he's getting my teleporter. That sucks really bad. Okay. So they're gonna, when he activates that thing, now what's gonna happen is he's gonna bring my fucking guys back to my ship, and that's a problem. So we don't like that. So now what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to run our guys back here. Run them into the med bay. And this missile is gonna be a serious fucking problem if it starts hitting important systems. And it looks like it's hitting my weapons, which means that that's gonna get shut down. Now, I don't know for a fact that it's actually gonna hit. We actually have 20% evasion here, and when our shields are down, it's gonna determine the hit when it crosses that room. And it does hit, and it gets a breach, so we gotta run our Mantis over to the weapons. We're gonna run these two Mantis and then this NG over to weapons, because he's gonna be better at putting out those fires. So this is like a pretty much worst case scenario kind of a situation here. That's a really annoying first fight for sure. So now if this hits our shields, we're in fucking big trouble. But it looks like it's okay. We actually dodged it. We have 15% evasion. We just have a Mantis in piloting, so that's not too bad. Okay, so now what I think I want to do here is we're gonna plan on, I want this small bomb to fire as fast as possible. So I'm gonna leave a guy manning that system. I'm gonna leave that one Mantis in piloting, and I'm just gonna go ahead and have this NG go here and man that system. And then I want this firing a little bit faster, because when he's manning the system, right, he's having a 10% faster charge time. Now that looks like it's going right for my fucking weapons. So fuck my life. If that hits my weapons, we're having a really bad time again. And that's what he's doing. Okay, so the good news here, potentially, is that they could run out of missiles before it ever becomes relevant. Okay, now they're gonna hit my fucking shields. That's a problem. That's a pretty huge problem. So I gotta send all my guys over here to try and repair these shields, because this heavy laser is gonna be doing us a tremendous amount of damage. Now, this whole time our FTL drive is charging, but that being said, we're still not ready to jump away. And he hit my weapons again. He hit my weapons again for the third time. Okay, now, Jesus Christ, this guy is a huge pain in my ass right now. Like, it's ridiculous. This is ridiculous. All right, now I hit an empty room. He still has missiles. His missile weapon has not gone away here. What's up, Copab? How you doing? This guy is really smart. Now, we are ready to jump away, so I could jump away if I have to. How much damage have we taken? We've taken, like, fuck. Let's move the window. Sorry. I don't think that's... I think I got it. Let me know if that's, this is wrong. This is when you restart. I mean, we don't restart around here, Aaron. That's not how I play. I play a game from the beginning to the end. So we're gonna, like, this is a situation that you might find yourself in, right? So we're gonna get a way out of it. Now, we could jump away. And I don't think I want to jump away. I'm going to be kind of stubborn here. We're going to plan on killing this ship. To be honest, this thing probably only has like 5 missiles left. Yeah, we don't ever fucking give up around here. We don't ever give up. If I can wait till this guy runs out of missiles, then we're in really good shape. All right, now what are you hitting here? Hit my weapons again? Of course you are, you fucking scumbag. You fucking scumbag. Ugh. What's up, Kong? How you doing today, my friend? Welcome, sir. To be honest, I should probably have this guy an engine, so that way we have slightly increased evasion. So he did... Okay, so this is supremely annoying. He actually started a fire in my oxygen, and in order to put it out, the fastest way for me to put it out is going to be to vent it out, and that's going to do the least amount of damage to my crew. I think I'm going to try, I'm going to go over there and I'm going to take a look. And if there's only one fire, then we'll try and have these guys put it out. Okay, there's 2 fires, so fuck that. We aren't putting out them fires with Mantis and an NG very quickly if there's 2 of them. So we'll just vent it out. And now, see, this is going to be a pretty big problem. We did dodge that missile. That's nice. This is the first fight. Yep. Taking a beating early on. Yep, no kidding. Oh, hold on. I just completely fucked up my whole crew's position here. You go here. Why don't you go here? All right, we're gonna vent out that oxygen. Now I gotta do is okay. Now even our teleporter is fucking on fire, which really sucks. And yet again, our weapons are fucking down because he just keeps firing them. So he's out of missiles. So the good news is they're out of missiles, right? That's great news. So this fire is still going on in the teleporter we can see here, but there is no fire in the oxygen, which is good, right? So he's out of missiles, so now we have the long-term fight here. I don't think any songs will be sung about this crew. Yeah, they don't need to sing songs because we're going to win, so it's not that big of a deal. Now, I'm not going to worry too much about that, to be honest, that fire. I don't think I have to worry about it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to close all the inner doors and then close all the doors and then open all the inner doors. This is going to equalize the oxygen within the ship. Even though there's no oxygen being produced, we can still equalize the oxygen that we have remaining in the ship. And this fire is still going on here in the teleporter. But I'm still gonna leave. I'm gonna leave this oxygen off because I don't want to fuel that fire, right? Because that fire is still going, right? We don't want to have that fire being fueled. We're just gonna continue to let that fire go, and we don't even need to dodge anything. I could just have this Mantis. We just want to wait for this fire to burn out here. I could send in these guys, to be honest, to try and put out the fire. But okay, there we go. The fire's out now, so we'll turn the oxygen back on. There's no risk of taking any more damage this entire fight. So we're going to take our time. And we're going to get a crew kill here. It's not too big of a deal. These guys aren't going anywhere. All right. And we'll get the small bomb active. All right. So, I mean, we very well could have run away there. But this is the first jump of the game. I'm not going. I ain't doing that. We're going to go get this teleporter repaired. And then he will be able to hack it then again. Too bad they didn't have a beam drone. If they had a beam drone, I'd fucking cry myself to sleep, pretty much. So our small bomb is ready to go. Okay, so what we want to be doing here is we want to take out their hacking. So that way we can actually teleport our guys over to their ship. So I'm just going to go ahead and activate shoot that bomb over there now. And that gets that taken out. Very nice. And we'll go ahead and send in this Mantis. And they're going to be going in there to repair, right? But we don't want them to fucking repair. Fuck that. We want them to die. So we're going to send our dudes over there. Now, here's a problem. This is pretty annoying right here. So many hits to the weapon room. It's all right, Spawn. It's all right, Spawn. It happens. It happens to everybody. That's why we stick around with the fight. We take them down. No problem. So this thing will repair no matter what. That auto repair drone just will come in and repair shit. It don't matter It don't matter whether or not it's like being attacked or not, and that's really, really, really annoying. And we don't want that to be happening. So I think what I'm going to be doing next, I'm going to take this small bomb. I'm going to pitch it. I'm going to pitch that right into their drums. Now, they don't have anybody in piloting right now. They don't have anybody in piloting, so their evasion is either zero or it's at least very reduced. So, because they got all three of their guys in here fighting my two Mantis. Now, we are taking a good bit of damage here, but that's all right. And they're sending, it looks like they're sending the Rockman. There must be a fire in there, maybe? No, there's not a fire. All right, so there's no fire. Now, I don't want three guys fighting my two Mantis. I ain't about that. We don't want that to be happening, right? So what we're going to do is I want to wait for this teleporter to be active here. And then we're going to send all of our crew over. And while we're waiting for our crew, we're just going to kind of run our Mantis around. They're super fast. I'm not too much worry about taking damage here. And our teleporter's ready to go. So we're going to go ahead and board them into the four-slot room here. Run like this. All right, very nice. So now we got four guys against their three. And even though we got some low health crew here, we're going to be doing just fine. And we're going to make sure to micro to make sure that everything does go fine. Alrighty. Alright, very nice. And they're dying nice and slowly here. And I don't really even have to rotate my crew, but I will just to kind of show an example here. So we'll put this Mantis. We don't want him fighting that Rockman because he's kind of getting low on health. So we'll switch him around here. Very nice. The game where you fight literally against the RNG. Well, see, that's the thing. Is like, a lot of people will complain about this game and they'll say, man, I got so fucking, like, that was like a very difficult fight, right? And we very well, it's like, it could have gone worse, but it went pretty bad. But it could have gone worse. And the thing is like, it's much, much like everything else is like, with any kind of game or anything like that, it's really not about how lucky or unlucky you get necessarily. I mean, overall in the run, it can be a pretty huge factor as to how busted you get. But as far as FTL goes, it's really all about like maximizing your gains while you have good luck and then trying to minimize the loss while you have bad luck. Like that was a difficult ship. It could have gone worse if it would have. Basically, if that missile would have hit our shields a couple more times, I probably would have tried to jump away because that heavy laser does a shitload of damage. And it would have been really bad, and we would have taken out like at least probably like 10 more damage if we would have stuck around if our shields were down. But our shields got hit once, we got them up, lickety split, right? And we got and we only took one hit from the darn thing, right? So it went pretty good. We got a really great reward. This is hard mode, right? So 5 fuel and 21 scrap is a tremendous reward. Like, that's, in general, like, 8 more scrap than what we might normally get. And as well as we got 5 fuel on top, which is also really fantastic, so. So there we go. We got that, and we'll get you guys back on the ship, get them healed. What's up, Snake? Thank you so much for the host, man. I appreciate it. Sorry I didn't, like, respond to you right away, but, I'm just trying to explain the best I can here. FTL is life indeed. Same in life as well. You just cannot sit there and complain about bad luck. I'm right there with you, Kong. Right there with you. You know, if you sit and complain about the problems that you're having, and it gets stuff done a lot faster if you just work on fixing the problem instead of complaining about it, right? Exactly. So, welcome, Kong. How you doing, man? How much scrap and repairs is needed? So, we took 11 points of damage there, so that right there is technically 22 points of repair. Now, that being said, I'm only going to be repairing up to, like, 25 hull, so we're only going to be spending, like, we're only going to be repairing, like, 6 hull instead of 11. So it's basically 12 scrap. And technically, I mean, we got 21 scrap. We took 22 scrap in damage, I think, right? I think that's how much we took. And, because each in sectors 1, 2, and 3, it costs 2 scrap per repair. So if we wanted to repair up to full, it would cost 22 scrap. But then, so we only got 21, but then we also got 15 scrap worth of fuel, because each fuel is worth 3 scrap, right? So we still came out ahead, technically, so. Nice spawns. First hard run, congrats, man. First of many. I promise, first of many, right? I gotta, speaking of things, I got to get my Twitch bot going here. So that we can have commands going on, because we don't have them right now. So 1 second, I'll get this over here. There we go. All right. All right, so let's get rocking here. So we got 20 fuel. That's a tremendous amount of fuel, and we're gonna hit these two jumps. Then we're gonna be planning on going to the store. And we got our, everybody's at full health. All systems are repaired. Okay, we're gonna get that power in our engines here. And all right. All right, so we have a, this is kind of an annoying ship, but it's really not too bad. So they are offering me a Mantis. Even if we had the scrap, I wouldn't buy it. We have plenty of crew, especially Mantis. And we also have an NG, which is nice. So we're going to be attacking the ship here. Now, they do have two lasers. So they have a heavy laser that fires in 9 seconds. They have a basic laser, same as ours, fires at 10 seconds. So this is fires first, this fires second. Now, the good thing is this is the one that sucks to get hit by, and that's the one that's going to be hitting us first. So we're, it's just going to be taking down our shields. If we get hit by both, the most damage we're going to be taking right off the bat is going to be 2, or 1 rather, so... It's not too bad of a ship, really. And the fact that it's a small ship, it's a slug-type ship, but we look in the top right, it's a pirate scout, so they're only gonna, I know from experience, they're only gonna have 2 crew on board. So what we're gonna be doing here is we're gonna attack them. What's up, April? How's it going? I'm doing well. How are you doing today? I'm glad to have the stream fixed and stuff like that. It seems to be working pretty well. So we're gonna attack the slaver scum here. Now this is, oops, I shouldn't have unpaused there. They have a guy. I know they're gonna have a guy in piloting. They're gonna have a guy in engines. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna board the guy where the guy is in engines. Now the reason I'm doing this is for a couple reasons. One is I want to try and get like an extra little hit on this guy before this guy is able to get into the room. We don't know how effective that's really gonna be. How do you know / decide when to and not to buy take crew? I almost never purchase crew cake. The only exception to that rule is basically. When using the NGB, because that ship only starts with 1 crew member, and you really need the crew really, really, really bad. So, I mean, for the most part, I don't purchase crew unless it's a good deal, or I really, really need them, or if they're a slug. I have a weak spot in my heart for slugs, and that's pretty much the only one that I buy. For the most part, there are exceptions. Like if I have extra scrap, then maybe I'll purchase an extra crew member. But for the most part, I mean, if I have 3... then that's usually enough. If I'm down to 2, then it's like the consideration is there, but I can't throw scrap away for the crew. But I mean, it really depends on how your style of play is, I suppose, for the game, because I'm really not a fan of, and in general, I'm not personally a fan of boarding, and so, because like it leaves us with only 2 guys on our ship, and sometimes I can still make mistakes and lose crew here during the boarding. So this is actually a really powerful enemy crew that they have here. They have a Mantis and a Rockman, so we're not going to be able to kill these guys in a straight-up fight, so we're going to try and like do a little bit of micro action here. And I'm going to move my Mantis into this next room, and you can see the Rockman's super fucking slow, right? And we have the Mantis Pheromone, so he's even slower in comparison. Have a weak spot for Rockman as they're able to tank some damage and stay in room. They're really good in a multi, in like a 4-slot fighting setup. Rockman are really powerful. So now this Rockman's takes forever to get into the room, right? So he's like, whoa, don't worry, I'm coming. So now we can move our Mantis back out of the room, and we could fight this Mantis for a little bit here while the Rockman's kind of running around. We run our Mantis down here. Now we get to fight their Mantis a little bit more. You can see he's getting chipped down really hard because we're fighting him 2v1 on our Mantis, right? Now, we did get hit by that thing, but that's all right. Okay, so we get some more hits here on him. Fantastic. And our small bomb's ready to go. Now, I don't want to really take any more damage from their ship, so I'm going to run my guys out of the piloting here. I'm going to go ahead and fire the small bomb. So that way, their guys are running out of the piloting, so they won't have a guy manning the ship, so their evasion is going to be reduced, right? So that's what we're doing there. And we did just kill their Mantis. So they are just completely screwed, right? They like, this guy is just 100% screwed. We got 2 Mantis against his 1 Rockman. And, like, we could just kind of... Like, if we just sat here, like, M6 is probably going to get pretty close to death and just fight him 2v1. Now, what I can do here... Do the Mantis pheromones work on the enemy ship? Yes. Yeah, my Mantis work faster. Yeah, the Mantis pheromones just increase your crew speed by 25%. Right. So here, let me show you a little kind of a micro trick that's really helpful here. Now, let's say, just hypothetically, that our teleporter's down, right? And both of my Mantis have, like, no health, Like, they have, like, less than 5 health or something like that. Like, they are screwed, and I gotta, like, take the time to go repair the teleporter or something like that. Or maybe I can't get it fixed because it's, like, on fire and my crew is, like, low and they're healing or something like that. So here's what we're gonna do. Let's say that we can't afford to get hit a single time by this Rockman, and we still want to kill him. Well, what if we still want to fucking kill him? We want to end the fight really fast. So here's what we do. Now, enemy AI will always prioritize shields over any other system. So here's what we do. So we run both of these guys into... Actually, let's run them both up here. Let's run them both up here, because he's going to be wanting to go to the slot up top here, right? So we run both these guys into an empty room. He sees there's two enemies in one room. He's like, I got to go fight that. So he cuts in the room, and then he comes in this way. Now if I run this guy into shields, watch what happens. He's like, whoa, there's a guy in shields. I got to turn around here. I got to get back into shields. And he's got to go all the way over to the console here. And so this whole time, we're getting free hits on him, right? So he comes back. And then we're like, well, just kidding, we're in here. Oh, nope, just kidding, we're in shields. So this whole time, we're just beating the crap out of this Rockman. He hasn't hit our guys once. Not a single time. Right? So this is a super powerful little micro tip here. And it's going to make sure that, like, even if your crew is almost dead, this is something that you could really, really kind of utilize to make sure that the enemy... just doesn't even have a chance, right? So that Rockman's completely screwed. He doesn't have a chance. And we get a nice reward here. 22 scrap of drone part, 2 missiles. Very, very nice. Bring you guys back. We'll get them in the med bay. Just paid 100% for attention. Yeah, no kidding, Kong. Everyone's like, whoa, what's he doing? What's this trick? It was a very nice one. So we got 43 scrap now. Now, if we were to go to the store right now, I wouldn't be too upset with it, because we got 43. Now we could sell the Mantis Pheromones. That sells for 25, if I remember correctly. So that means, like, we could buy, if we sold the Mantis Pheromones, like, we could buy a Flak. We could, if we sold the Mantis Pheromones and the Small Bomb, we could buy a Burst Laser 2, although with our weapons, we could not power it. But no problem, Darkless. My pleasure, man. So, but we got one more jump, at least, before going to that store. So we're going to be jumping here, try and make ourselves a little bit more money. See what we got here. So they want drone parts. We don't have drone parts, so that sucks. That's all right, though. So we'll ignore the station here. All right, so now, ooh, interesting. So now we have a distress here. Like, this jump is not going to cover the store for one more jump. And you can use either a fleet advancement mod, and it'll show you a graphic, like, literally right over your game where the jump's going to be. I use a sheet of paper. I just have, like, the fleet advancement, like, kind of marked out on the sheet of paper, just like that space that they jump. I put it up. I literally, like, put it up to the screen, and I check it, and we're perfectly fine. So I think what I kind of want to do here is, like, I want to go to the distress and then the store, but then where do we go after that? Then we'd either have to go to the nebula here, which might not be bad. My most favorite weapons, probably the... I don't know, I always kind of switch it around. I guess I like the flak or the fire beam. It depends on what kind of a mood I'm in. I really like the fire beam. It's a fun weapon. It's not super powerful or anything like that, but it creates some pretty interesting stuff. But I like the flak in general is probably going to be my best answer. Like, we could go distress and then the store, and then we still have space to go into the nebula and then kind of clear out this area before going to the exit. I think that's probably the best, because with distresses, we have some pretty good blue options, so it's probably in our best interest to hop over to the distress, because we have a teleporter, we have an NG. Both of those are going to give us some interesting options like we might not normally have. So I think we're going to hop over to the distress here. Alright, so we have a nearby human mining colony where an unknown disease has spread virulently. So we can send an RNG to calm down the infected. We have a blue option here. If you don't have a blue option, do not pick number one. Don't do it, because you will lose a crew member most of the time. And even if you have a clone bay, you won't get them back, because it's a quarantine. Like, they get cloned and they still have the damn problem, so... We're going to send our energy to calm down the affected. This is usually not a really great reward. There's a rare instance, like if you have NG medbot dispersal with a level 2 medbait, you get a really great reward from this one. It's really... I've never had it before, so... So, with no fear of catching the disease, your NG crew member helps reassure and organize infected humans. Calmed by its extensive knowledge of human physiology, the infected submit to the quarantine in the hopes that the cure can be found soon. So we got 9 scrap, 3 missiles, and a drone part. Not the worst, not the greatest. Oh, you know what? Actually, that's a... you know what? You asked me what my favorite weapon is. My favorite weapon is actually a heavy laser one. I don't know. I kind of just had a brain fart there. Heavy laser one is my favorite weapon. Yeah, it's actually... Yeah, like if you... On the FTL Reddit, that's what my like little emote thing is next to my name is a heavy laser one. I love it. It's a circus of value is what that thing is. So we're going to be hopping back to the store here. And we might not get any repairs here. I'd like to get repairs, but if there's something that we want to buy, we might not have the extra scrap to do so. But we'll hop over to the store at least. And let's see what we got here. Okay. So we got drone control, sensors, and a clone bay. A couple of NGs and a mantis. Not interested in those. Not really interested in any of these weapons. Like the charge laser is something that we could potentially use down the line, but certainly not in a 3-weapon setup. We're not really interested in doing that, so... Alright, so I think I might sell the Mantis Pheromones here, so that way I have a little bit of extra scrap, because there's one thing that I really want to do, and it's pretty much the most powerful upgrade you can possibly make in the game, is getting your shields to level 2. And it's a total of 50 scrap to allow yourself to have level 2 shields. So that's only going to leave us with 2 scrap. And like I said, I do want to get repairs on the ship. And to be honest, I think I can probably make this work without the Mantis Pheromones. It won't be too difficult. So I think we're probably just going to go ahead and do that. I think I'm going to upgrade my shields. Yeah. And then I think, yeah, like, I don't want to sell these weapons because if we run into a drone ship, that's going to be our only method of killing it, right? So we're going to sell the Mantis Pheromones, give me some extra scrap. We're going to get our hole up a little bit there. All right, now, even though I don't necessarily have the power to have the shields online, I can just pull my engines, and then when we're actually getting shot at, I can pull my oxygen and put that into my engines there, but... We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. It's just getting level 2 shields just greatly increases the amount of ships through sectors 1 through 3 that you can fight that just can never do any damage. Like, you fight a lot like that last ship, that slug ship type pirate ship that we fought, that just could just not deal us damage if we had 2 shields. So it just really makes the level 2 shields super, super powerful. So highly recommend that. Yeah, speedruns, beam weapons are extremely important because they give you really good consistency. Especially with hacking. Extremely powerful, Kong, yep. I believe the world record speedrun is held with the stealth B ship, if I remember correctly. Alright, so we're going to be hopping over into the nebula here. Now, we do get some blue options by having a teleporter, so that's kind of nice, but otherwise, we're just kind of going to be hoping that we don't get any crappy events, because there are some crappy events in the nebula. Okay, so here we have a drone automated ship, and let's see. Advanced automated ship remains stationed near a small rebel space station, so we're going to attack the automated ship so that way we can get to the station. Now, what can we see about this drone ship? We can see they have a mini beam, and I know that that fires at 12 seconds, and we can also see down here that they have drone control, right? They got that drone control, so they could have a beam drone, or they could have a combat drone. But with level 2 shields, we should be in pretty good shape, right? So we'll go ahead and attack this. Let's unpause and pause really quick so we can see what kind of drone they have. Okay, they just have a beam drone. So literally, all we have to do is have shields online, and we're in great shape. And we're not going to be boarding them, so I'm just going to have these guys man systems here. Doesn't really matter. So all we need is those shields online, we're going to be in great shape. And so what we need to do here to kill this ship is we'd use our small bomb on their shield. And we got a lucky hit there, so we'll turn the small bomb off, turn the basic laser on. And he does have an extra point in shield, so we want to take that basic laser and we want to fire that right into their shields. And try not to use auto fire if you can help it, because it just helps a lot, making sure you don't misfire your weapons if you're not auto firing. Just take your time. And just gonna go ahead and hit their piloting, that way they can't dodge, and then we'll take out their engine, that way they really can't dodge. And they do auto repair, right? So, I mean, they will have this stuff repaired eventually, but it doesn't really matter what the systems we damage at this point. They only had 1 point in their piloting and their engine, so they're having a pretty bad day over there. So they did start to repair those shields there, so we're just gonna go ahead and shoot those down right away. There we go. Alrighty. And we'll just target their piloting. It's probably gonna be repaired right about the time that we fire here, if I had to guess. No, maybe not. Oh, there it goes. Alright, we'll fire on it again. So it's only got 2 health here, just waiting for it to die. That's all we need, is for them to die. Alright. Slam jam. And the Rebel Space Station is not a guaranteed reward of any kind, but there's a possibility of getting like a crew member or something like that. So 15 scrap, we'll investigate the station. 10 scrap on a small bomb. Now, we already have a small bomb. We're not going to be using a second one, but that's certainly nice to get us something that we could sell at the store. We're going to have our guys get back in the teleporter. Alright, so we have 36 scrap here. Do I want to do anything with that before jumping up to the nebula? Let's see, I think we're going to go ahead and hit both of these nebulas, and then after those two nebulas, then it looks like we'll have 4 jumps after that. And remember, since we're in a nebula, the Rebel fleet advances half, so I could get my piloting to level 2, and the reason that I would be interested in doing that is there's an event that happens in nebulas where it's in an ion storm, and there's a wreckage that you can search either manually, or if you have level 2 piloting or higher, then you can have a blue option as far as that goes. But it's not, I don't know if it's really common enough, and it's not a guaranteed reward. So it's debatable whether it's really worth the upgrade or not, I suppose. Typically, I do utilize it, but 2 small bombs. Go for the double dunk. Yeah, we don't even have our weapons online. Actually, maybe I should just save my scrap so I can try and get my weapons to level 2. Getting my engines to level 3 is also a very relevant upgrade, but yeah, I'm gonna get my engines to level 3. Now, if we're fighting, the reason that I want to do this before like getting power is that if we're fighting a ship that has 1 laser and like 1 missile, kind of like that first one that we fought, then maybe we can pull our oxygen here while the missile's firing at us and up our evasion to 25% instead of 20. So that's pretty relevant, right? So let's keep on keeping on here. All right, so now we have an ion storm, and this is exactly that frickin' vent that event that I was just talking about. Alright, so this is exactly that event that I was talking about. So this is a manually searched wreckage. If you just do number 1 here, you have a chance to lose a crew member. So unless you have a clone bay, you don't really want to be doing that. So that sucks, but rip a pepperonis. We're going to avoid the risk. Not gonna throw a crew member away for that, so we're going to get our shield online. Now, when you jump away from any kind of an event, you really want to make sure that your shield's online, because if we jump to a beacon and they have a drone, what if they have a beam drone? Right? So, like, they'll, like, be already at your ship and, like, almost ready to fire. And sometimes if our shields are down, right, and you power them up right at the beginning of the fight, during that period of time, he can move into position and take a hit onto your ship, right? So that's pretty bad. So we don't want that to happen. Having a drone also gives a blue option. Not as far as I know. I don't know of any drone that gives you a blue option there, but I could be wrong. Pirate ship arrives shortly after you. Judging from the fact that it is attempting to avoid your ship, you assume that it is a smuggler trying to stay away from the beacons. We're certainly going to attack the pirate here. All right, so this is a ship with a missile and a small laser here. And so we're going to be utilizing that strategy that I just told you about before. And usually on these ships, there's only two crew, so I'm just going to go ahead and board the engines here, because that's where I know where one of them is going to be in that case. And they have a Zoltan and an NG, so this is going to be a pretty easy-peasy one. They're going to die pretty quick. Now, the Zoltans do explode for 15 points of damage to all crew on the ship, but we should be fine here, because the NG doesn't do shit for damage. So the small missile here is going flying at our ship. It's just a one-damage missile, and there's a couple of reasons that we can tell that that's the case. And one of them is that it fired before this basic laser, and the basic laser fires at 10 seconds, and a one-damage missile fires at 9 seconds, and a two-damage missile fires at 10 seconds, so it would have fired at the same time as this. The other thing that we can tell is it has a two-damage missile has wings on the front here, and this one does not. So we know it's just a one-damage missile, but I still pull my oxygen here and put it into my engines to give ourselves that 25% evasion. So 1 in 4 times it won't hit us. Even if it does, it's not the end of the world. We do dodge it in this case, so since we dodged it, I'm going to go ahead and keep my engines up for that laser shot as well. Not that we have to dodge it. We got lucky and we did dodge it. So that's awesome. But we don't have to dodge it because it's not going to deal us damage. But that being said, we still want to get some training in, right? We want to get these guys trained in our piloting and engines, because that's very valuable. When they get up to level 1 and level 2 in those... in those skills, then they are going to increase our evasion even more. So since those shots have already passed us now, we already dodged both of them, we'll put that power back into our oxygen. Try not to suffocate the crew too much. But so these guys are going to die super easy. Remember, this guy explodes for 15 damage, so suddenly we're at a really low amount of health. And again, with getting crew kills, very, very powerful, you greatly increase the chance of you getting these types of nice rewards, right? So the ship refuses to fight, but you still detect life signatures. Apparently this was a prisoner transport. So we find a Mantis, his name is Zinzin, and we got 22 scrap on top of it. So that's a fantastic event. So we'll continue here. We got ourselves a Mantis named Zinzin. We're going to get you guys in the med bay, get you healed up. And we got to get this guy renamed really quick. So as usual... Sponsk, you can get the name there. Whoever talks most recently in chat that's not already named gets the name. And you're going to be going and manning weapons over there. We really don't need any more Mantis on the ship, to be perfectly honest. It'd be not a lot nicer to just get some crew that's good at repairing. So either another NG or like Rockman or anybody that's just not reduced. Not reduced in repair speed would be fantastic. Anything that's not a Mantis. Alright, so we got 4 jumps here before we gotta be going to the exit. So we're probably gonna plan on something like 1, 2, 3, 4 or something like that, or 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know. We'll jump here first, and that's gonna show us 4 beacons, and then we can decide from there. So now I kinda wanna get my weapons up another level here. So that it's 40 scrap, so that first level is really expensive. You can see in the right here that it's 40 and then it goes down to 25. But that first level of system power is expensive. But you know what? I'm not going to spend the scrap yet, and here's why. When I jump to this beacon, we're going to see 4 beacons, and one of them could very well be a store. So maybe we don't want to spend that scrap, so we could try and spend it at a store, right? So. No, wait, man. Okay, hang on. I must have hit a key here that adjusted my text size, so we want to up that. There's plus and minus on your keyboard, adjust the text size. We're not going to find Kazakh Plethkalik unless we get the Mantis homeworlds. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how they came up with that name. I'm not sure. Alright, so all of Muratai's ships have been destroyed or damaged during the rebellion. However, there have been reports of a Mantis war camp only a few jumps from us. Can you help? So we'll pledge to do what we can here, and just by agreeing, we will get a reward. And if we do swing by, the only blue option that's actually successful in that quest is having a firebomb. But we're not going to be going there, basically. Like, generally, the only thing that happened is when we get a basic just Mantis ship fight. But if we had firebombs, then we'd have a blue option that was actually successful. Any kind of missiles or bombs give a blue option, but they're not successful. Only the firebomb is, so. We got 3 jumps left here. I'm probably just going to jump here first, so that way we spot both of these beacons down here. And then if one of them's a store or distress, then great. And then basically if I jump here and we don't see a store, then I'm going to spend my scrap. And if we do jump and see a store, then we'll hold it. So this is another mercenary ship here. And they have a heavy laser that we can see. But there's also a lot of stuff, other stuff that we can see on the ship too, right? So they have a drone control here. They have a med bay, and they have door control. And those doors might be upgraded or they might not. We don't know yet. But we're going to fight the ship here for sure. With level 2 shields, we should be excited to try to kick the flu. Slept for 24 hours. I'm not good. And I'm good, but now fucked for finals. Oh, Copab. Brother, that sucks. Best of luck, man. I don't know what you could do. There might be some kind of thing that you could do to try and get an extra day or an extra couple hours or something. I really don't know, but I'm glad you're feeling better, but that stinks, man. You have my best wishes and good luck. Hopefully you can do okay, you know what I mean? All right, so let's see what kind of a drone they have. So they have an anti-drone drone, and they must have like an anti-ship drone. Now we can see that their doors are not upgraded, but with our one level of shields, they can't deal us damage, right? So we're in good shape here. What's up, Chunk? How's it going, man? Well, at least you're not feeling like crap, though. Physics final at number 2 in 1 hour. Oh my goodness, man. Contact your professor. Sometimes they will accommodate for sickness to give you an extra day. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, it depends on the professor, I guess. But so we're gonna be boarding here, and they probably have like an anti-boarding drone. Yeah, they do. So I just boarded the drones just to see. But yeah, that's exactly the case. And we definitely want to kill them. Ugh, like this is a little bit annoying. We're probably gonna send these two Mantis in afterwards. We're just gonna kind of run our crew around here for a minute, so that way we'll be in better standing to fight these guys. And they do have they have a Mantis on their ship as well. I think they have two humans and a Mantis. That's what it looks like to me. So we're just going to run our crew around here. And once we get all of our crew in, we'll be in a little bit better shape. And we're probably, once we get on board, Actually, you know, I could use a small bomb in their drones and get this anti-personnel drone shut down if I wanted. Or I could just wait and use it on the medbay. Let's just shut down this stupid drone. Fuck that thing. I don't like that thing. That ain't cool. I ain't down with that. Alright, so we got that anti-boarding ship thing drone shut down. We're gonna get these Mantis boarding their ship as well. And now we got four Mantis fighting three guys. And they do have a medbay. That being said, they're gonna run two guys to the medbay and then we'll murder one of them. While the other one's still here, right? So I'm just gonna go ahead and we're gonna do this as though we didn't have a small bomb at this point. Dude, it's doing a lot better today, Chunk. We had a lot of problems when I first started off, but it's doing okay now, and I'm pretty happy with it. But yeah, we had a lot of problems right off the bat, but it seems like it's doing okay. Yeah, no kidding. What's up, Zooktar? Cram like you've never crammed before. You need to install a chip into your head, maybe. Yeah, maybe you strike lucky and get an FTL question. No shit, all right. So that Mantis is going to run to the medbay. He's running the medbay. This guy's running the medbay too. So now the medbay's full, right? So this guy ain't going anywhere. This guy's not going nowhere. All right, fantastic. So now what our plan is here is we want these enemies to come and fight our guys, right? But we want to take out their medbay. So basically, wherever these guys come to fight, so they want to come and fight in the oxygen. Let's see. Will they come and fight over here? Seems like they just want to. All right. What do you prefer? Do you guys prioritize that? Okay. Right, what do you guys prioritize? Weapons? Maybe. No, I know they're gonna prioritize shields, but it's like right next to the fucking med bay, so I don't really want to do that. But here we go. All right. So here's what we're doing. So now these guys have a priority, right? Thanks, Sonhound. How you doing, man?
Welcome back, brother. Oh, yeah, brother.
These guys prioritize shields. Like I said, it's the highest priority for enemy AI. And we want to have our Mantis here taking out their med bay here.
Do-do-do, do-do-do, do-do-do.
You think the dishwasher's fixed now? Awesome. Cool. That's awesome, Kuro. So we're gonna have our guys hitting down the med bay here. And these guys are fighting here. Now these guys, okay, so now their med bay's down. So now the only thing we gotta worry about is making sure that these enemies die. And our best case for getting these crew dead is moving them into this four slot room. So now we're getting our guys attacking them all. Very nice. Okay, so I want this mantis is pretty low on health, so I'm gonna kind of rotate him out here. Very nice. And now our two mantis with the most health are attacking them, and we kill them super quick. So that, there we go. So now we didn't have, we used it as though we didn't have a small bomb after we disabled their drone, because that was just going to be kind of a wild card that I didn't want to deal with. But so we move our guys into shields to take their priority away, because once they're health, they don't want to be in the med bay. They want to go somewhere else. And so we have our two guys with more health fight the shields. We have our other two mantis take down their, with low health, take out their med bay, and then once their med bay is down, we can just basically run them wherever, because they won't run to repair the med bay, because they crazy. So 20 scrap, one missile, and a drone part. Pretty solid reward. Very solid reward, in fact. Let me get this med bay online. And you don't, even though there's only three slots in this med bay, I can just like run this guy back and forth in this little spot, and he actually does get healed here. Since he's like in and out of the room for just a half second, he won't get healed like super duper fast, but if he needed to have him in the room, then he could. Same is true on any ship. So we got 78 scrap to work with now. We see there's no store here at all. So here's what I'm going to be doing here. I'm going to be getting my weapons up another level, and I'm going to be getting one bar of power. And what I'm planning on doing with this power for right now is putting that into the basic laser. That way, if we fight a drone ship, we can have our small bomb and our basic laser active. If we're fighting a ship that isn't a drone ship or we don't need this basic laser online, then I'll turn it off and put it into engines. Or we'll put the two power into shields, and then we can like pull our oxygen and give ourselves a little bit more evasion with two shields as well. So for right now, we'll do that. I'm just using hotkeys for all this stuff. And if you want to, you can actually go into your options, and you can go to configure keyboard hotkeys. And I don't have any of my stations bound to specific keys anymore, to the specific stations. Like you can see that, page two. So powering shields, engines, oxygens, like all these things do not have keys. But what I've switched them to is powering system 1 through 8. Is just all through ASDF, GH, JK, right? So that's the way that I have it. So no matter what systems I do or don't have, it's always just across like that. So sometimes it's more useful than others, but just FYI, if you ever felt like screwing around with the binds to the game. I played the game enough where I screw with the binds. That's how you know I played it too much. So we're gonna be hitting two jumps here, and then we're gonna be going to the exit. And we're in really great shape here, to be perfectly honest. Like I said, we're not going to bother going to the quest. Even if we wanted to, we couldn't make it. So, not without having to dive before the exit. You find a small space station that appears to be abandoned. If we move into the exam... Yeah, we're going to move into the exam of the station. I think that we can get boarded by moving in here. To be honest, I can't remember this event very well. I don't think there's any risk of losing crew member right immediately, but we'll do that. Alright, so we have to fight a pirate ship, and we're getting boarded automatically, and they have a heavy laser, and they also have drone control, and we can see that on their ship, but I always just kind of default down here. They have door control, they don't have a med bay, so let's see what kind of people we're getting boarded by here. Okay, they have a defense drone too. That's pretty funny, and they do have their doors upgraded, so let's deal with these boarders first. Looks like they're running down into my shields, I think? Yeah, alright, so let's run all of our guys into their shields. And they got two guys boarding us. They got a Rockman and a Zoltan. But with our one level of shields, we're not at any risk of taking damage against the ship. So we'll just deal with these boarders. And then we'll go ahead and get our guys healed. And then we'll figure it out from there. Now, because they have this defense drone too, that shoots down not only missiles, but also lasers. So I don't have any interest of using a basic laser here. Basically, what I'm planning on doing is just probably... throwing a small bomb into their door system, and then from there possibly sending more crew after these two. Now, before I shoot the small bomb into their doors, I'm going to go ahead and board them first, and then we'll do it. So that way, there's going to be a guy not in their... actually, in this case, it's not going to be in their piloting. And so it's going to be a reduced evasion. So he was rotating his guys in and out. Very nice. And he's got this Engie over here fixing his doors. So I want to kind of... Well, I want to fight the Engie because he's really squishy, right? He doesn't do... Well, he's not squishy, but he doesn't do much damage. He does reduced combat damage. Same as your Engie, right? He does less combat damage. That's the way that they... If you look at the crew profile, it says they do reduced damage. So we'll just murder these guys first, and then... These guys are going to die really quick. Now, we did take a bunch of damage and from that Zoltan exploding, but I think we're still in pretty okay shape here. We could probably kill this guy without having to do much. Like, I got a micro him, but... So I'll let this guy take one more hit there, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to move them both out of the room, and then I'm going to move the guy with low health in first and then him second, so that way they switch out. So he's down to 2 fucking health. That was a little bit risky of me, to be perfectly honest, but that's all right. We will have this guy dead. We can see that our guy has 40 health. He's only got 28, so he's gonna die very shortly here. 22 scrap, 2 missiles, and a drone part. It was kind of like, even though they were switching positions, he was in that spot for too long, so he got an extra hit on him as he was moving, so that was a problem. But fortunately, we didn't lose a crew member there. It was kind of risky. Should have moved him before he was that low. Do you farm XP in these situations? I don't farm XP, Aronk, But I mean, there's nothing wrong with farming XP. I just don't find it to be very entertaining to watch, so I don't do it for the stream. You know what I mean? And I don't play FTL anymore. That's not on stream, so. So the answer is no, I don't do that. Ugh, delicious. All right. Put you guys back in the teleporter. And we get this powered, and we'll hop over here, and then we're going to be hopping over to the exit after that. Okay, so this is an interesting... I like these fights. Not the ship that we're fighting, but these events are nice. So you detect a rebel scout attacking a small refueling outpost. So if we defend the outpost here, we have a guaranteed double reward because the outpost doesn't go anywhere, right? As long as we destroy the ship, then we're going to get 2 rewards. One from destroying the ship and another from the outpost. You start counting win streak? No, Chunk, I'm not counting any win streaks. Although I can't remember the last time we lost. We don't play FTL enough to really bother counting for a win streak right now. I'm not even saving FTL runs anymore, so... I have no interest in trying to beat my own record of 39 ships in a row. It's pretty crazy as it is. So they do have drone control, they have a med bay, they don't have door control, they have a heavy laser, and they have a small missile, either a 1 or 2 damage one. Now we're going to see what kind of a drone they have. And they have a... That's pretty annoying. They have this freaking shield drone, and that's annoying because it puts up a shield on his ship, and it... you can't board through it and you can't teleport bombs through it. So I'm going to have to use a basic laser to shoot it down and then teleport a bomb in afterwards. So we are going to board right away so that way we can get our guys in before the shield goes up. But we'll board here. And because they have a guy in weapons, I know they have at least 3 crew on board. They probably have 3, but... So we're going to sit here and we'll fight this guy. Now here's what we're going to do. Here's a nice micro trick for you guys. Okay, so we're on a ship here. They have 3 crew. Now, when I move my guys into this room, you'd think that these 2 guys would follow me, but that's not the way that the AI works. They're going to bring their guy from piloting and this guy, and they're going to fight. They're going to fight me here, and this guy is going to go into piloting, or one of these 2 guys is going to go into piloting. Only one's going to follow me. They're going to switch their pilot out here. And this is really great for me because it gives me the whole time that it takes their pilot to run from piloting down here, I get to fight 2 Mantis versus 1 of their guys. So boom. So now this guy was the guy in piloting. He's back in piloting. So now we're going to do the same thing. We move to the room down here. And they do that same switch around. The old switcheroo, eh? Yeah, that's exactly what happens. Right, so... they did fire their missile and the heavy laser here. I'm gonna up my evasion by pulling my oxygen here. And we're gonna do the same switcheroo here, because I'm gonna be firing my basic laser here, and we're gonna be firing the small bomb right afterwards, so... we don't want to have their guy in piloting, and I also want to small bomb their weapons, so we're gonna fire this. Now, there's no guy in piloting, and can see the door opening. Hopefully that fucking missile doesn't hit my weapons. Well, even if it does, it's fine, because it's only a one damage one, and it's only going to take out my basic laser, which I've already fired. Okay, so... okay, it actually hit this empty room here. But, I'm going to have these guys go repair that. And then, so I'm going to fire the small bomb into their weapons. I want to take out that missile, make sure that we don't have any problems there anymore. Fantastic. And they do have this drone still online, and they also have the medbay, which is very annoying. No, we don't want them to have a medbay, but I can't do anything about it yet. I'm gonna have to small bomb it down, or I could send in these two mantis, to be honest. Maybe that's the better play. It could be. Yeah, probably. I'm just not gonna worry about that repair in that case, and I'm gonna use this basic laser to shoot that thing down, and we'll send in these two mantis to go help out their bros. Right. So this guy dies. We kill that guy. Very nice. We're going to send these two mantis into their shields. Now the AI is going to prioritize shields. Okay, this guy's too low on health, and I don't want to kill this guy yet. I don't want him to be so low on health that so that he doesn't. Okay, there we go. So now I'm going to have these two guys go into medbay. And then take that down while these guys are fighting that. And now I don't want this guy to get low enough where he runs to a different room. So I'm just going to run this mantis back and forth right now so that he's not dealing damage to this guy. Because, you know what I mean? Like, if we get this guy low enough where he runs to the medbay, then my guys can't deal damage to their medbay, right? So that's not what I'm about right now. So we're going to run this guy back and forth so he's not dealing damage. And we take down their medbay. So now we're like, well, you're dead now. So we run all of our mantis in here, kill all their crew, and they're screwed. Another small bomb? Who's fucking leaving these things around in space? What's going on? Where the fuck are these things coming from? We got 22 scrap, a small bomb, 2 fuel, and a missile. Okay. And then this Zoltan shield thing goes away. But then, on top of that, we get the fueling outpost reward, right? Because they're like, the pompous bastards expected free service. Well, we were here to help. 16 scrap and 2 fuel on top of it. So that's a fantastic set of rewards. Our second small bomb. I don't know what the fuck they're leaving around in space. Triple small bomb. Fucking great. Woohoo. Can't wait, bud. I'm actually just have you run in there. Now, we do have this breach, though. I'll have the engine go repair it, and then I'll have them heal up afterwards. And remember, even if our oxygen's off, we can turn our oxygen off, so this room's not going to refill with oxygen, but we open all of our inner doors, that's going to equalize the oxygen, right? So, exactly. That's what we're doing. There we go. What's up, Mysterious? How you doing, man? Overstock.com had a special on small bomb. Yep. Oh my goodness. Need more coffee. We're ready for the flagship. Oh yeah. We're so ready to go. I can't wait. Alright, so we got 78 scrap. That's plenty of scrap, but I'm not going to spend any of it right now. I want to wait until I get into the next sector, because there's a possibility that we jump into Sector 2, and we just have a store right there off the bat, so it would be nice to be able to spend it. Always want to see as many jumps as you can before spending your scrap. Receive a message from a nearby station. A Federation cruiser jumping into the Rebel territory. Quite a bold move. Lucky for you, we're not on support of the Rebellion. 18 scrap, 3 fuel, and a missile. Not too bad at all. We're up to 96 scrap. This is a fantastic Sector 1, for sure. We've made a ton of scrap here. Now, there's a pirate-controlled sector, and there's also a civilian sector. And both of these are actually pretty darn tempting, to be perfectly honest. Pirate-controlled sectors, we're going to be fighting more pirate ships, so when we get crew kills on them, especially, we're going to be having a lot better chance of getting free crew members, which we are all about. So I think we're probably actually going to go pirate over civilian sector. Like, if this was an NG-controlled sector, we certainly go NG-controlled, like, every single time. A lot more scrap to be made there, especially because we have an NG crew member. More stores, more distresses, easier ships in general, but I think I want to go ahead and take pirate control here. In general, civilian sectors are a little bit easier, except for Zoltan sectors are generally pretty difficult, but, the kind of sectors that you want to avoid are going to be, like, rock-controlled sectors and, things like rock-controlled sectors, rebel-controlled sectors are really nasty, and stuff like that, so. But rebel strongholds are very nice, though, that being said. Rebel strongholds are very nice. There's a very nice event that happens there. So, Federation-friendly planets still exist in this sector, but they're constantly under attack by pirates. And speaking of the fact that we can get more crew members by killing pirate ships, is like that event just said, there's actually a lot of civilians that are under attack by pirates, so we have more chances for double rewards here. So that's also nice. So we jump here, we see there's no stores, and so I'm going to go ahead and spend, like, I'm going to get a bar of power here. And I think that's all I'm going to do for right now. I can get another bar of power. I'm going to get another bar of power. That's fine. That sounds good. Alrighty, let's keep on keeping on. Alright, I think I'm going to jump. I think I'm going to jump here. It's going to show us three beacons we haven't seen yet. Then we'll probably jump here. That'll show us four beacons. Actually, three more beacons that we haven't seen yet. So let's jump here first. Okay, so these people, they want me to buy their rockmen. I ain't about buying crew, man. We're going to get our crew for free, thank you very much. Now, they do have a missile and a basic laser, so we only need one shield up here. They don't have any med bay or nothing like that. It's a rock-type ship, but we can see in the top right, it's a pirate ship, so we don't know what's going to be inside. It could be rockmen, it might not be. I'm just going to pull my shields, that way I can just have my engine powered all the time and don't have to worry about microing it. We're going to jump in their ship. And again, I'm going to just go ahead and board their engines because we know there's going to be a guy there. And these guys are going to die so fast, it don't even matter. It don't even matter. Indeed, Abel, it is working very nice. I'm very happy. It's going good. No huge errors yet, so that's fantastic. And we're just going to kill these guys. I'm not going to bother even trying to small bomb their weapons. Now, that being said, this missile fired at the same time as this. And I'll show you that wing I'm talking about on the missiles. Here comes that shot. We didn't dodge that one. Hopefully, we dodged the missile. But see, I told you the missile, the one that does 2 damage, has this wing on it. That's what shows us that it's dealing 2 damage, right? So that's what that is. So hopefully, we dodge. If not, it's no big deal. Whatever. Okay, there is a fire in there. Okay. I can't really hear very well. My volume's kind of screwy, but we'll get this fires put out. And alright, so here we go. So this is probably like the best kind of reward that you can actually get from this type of a fight. You find a number of slaves in the cargo hold. They look at you questioningly, and one asks if they're going to be released. You could use more crew, but you don't want to force them all to work for you. Instead, so we already have a Mantis. We already have an NG. And so we would love a Rockman. Rockmen have blue options. They have a lot of health. They're slow, but they repair at the same rate that anybody else does. So we're definitely interested in the Rockman, obviously. So we're going to take that. And we also get a scrap reward here. We get 19 scrap, drone part, and 2 missiles. And we get a Rockman named Kletskin. And Rockmans don't take damage from fire as well. It's kind of another thing to note, I suppose. And Stirfry is already named. Looks like Abel gets the name. There you go, my friend. Mantis are awful at putting out fires, by the way. They put out fires the same as they repair. They repair at half speed, so they are not efficient at that shit at all, but I'm still having them do it because, you know, well, they look like they're having fun. Okay, we're going to have you. I'm going to probably going to have this Rockman man in weapons, actually. And I'm going to have one of the Mantis, actually, like, man doors, probably, instead of shields. Yes, you gotta go to work, Abel. I'm sorry. All right, so which one of these Mantis is going where? All right, so I'm actually going to have you man doors, Mr. Mantis. So Spont's got maybe kind of a downgrade there, but that's fine. We want to. The reason I'm having Mandors instead of shields here is that at the beginning of fight, that's when you get boarded at the very instance of the first fight. So we want to have a guy manning doors so that way we can control where they can and cannot go as best we can. So after that, there's some. They're like manning shields is relevant in certain fights, but for the most part, right off the bat, we want to have a guy manning doors. If you really wanted to micro super properly, you'd have a guy manning doors at the beginning of every fight if you didn't have an extra crew member, and then you'd have him move to shields immediately afterwards. So I'll head over to the distress here. I'll get my shields up to level 2 here. It's no Rock A, right? What's up, Pandemonium? FTL, I thought you quit this game because space was not as dark as the darkest dungeon. I'll never quit FTL, Pandemonium. I mean, I've certainly played the game a lot, and you know what I mean, but we don't ever quit FTL. But what's up, Gratskin? I don't talk about that stuff on the stream, so sorry about that, bud. So once we arrive at the location of the distress call, civilian ship hails you. Thank you for responding to our beacon. Our FTL navigation has gone haywire. We can't plot a course to the nearest depot. So could you lead us there? Sure. I'm sure it's going to be a trap. We're going to be attacked by a Federation or a rebel ship or whatever. But we get 8 scrap for you just agreeing to it. And this quest is over here. And there is a store here, which we're definitely interested in hopping over to the store. Because we have a bit of excess of small bombs, to say the least. So we're gonna be hopping over to that store there. Okay, so we got a pike beam, a stun bomb, and a Pegasus missile. Bum 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 bum. They have a drone control with a defense drone, backup battery, clone bay. I mean, technically a clone bay is better than a med bay, but that being said, it's not like better enough to really consider replace. Like, it's a pretty significant scrap loss, 50 scrap, especially on hard mode, so not ever really worth replacing one with the other. Scrap recovery arm, battery charger, and FTL recharge booster. Not interested in any of those. Scrap recovery arm is a very luxury item, especially on hard mode. If you absolutely have like 50 just extra scrap that you just don't need, you might as well throw it away, then buy a scrap recovery arm. It's not like it's only really going to be relevant sector 4 and onwards, because that's when you're actually getting like more than 20 scrap generally, but in general, not really very good. Now, defense drones are not super good on this ship, and the reason is just like the shape of the ship. It's a pretty large ship. It's very kind of awkward. It's shaped like an egg, the shield is, because you got to understand that the defense drone goes along the shield line, right? And so if it's over on this end of the ship, it's pretty much going to miss all the missiles that are heading and hitting this portion of the ship. If it's anywhere else, it's like it's not too bad, but this whole portion of the ship and these side rooms, which are the most important ones, will frequently get hit without the defense drone being able to shoot it down. So FTL's like a drug, you can never quit it, you know, like pizza. Exactly. Oh, it's a pizza. Like, I don't think it's necessarily incorrect to purchase drone control with the defense drone here, but it's not very good with the ship. If it targets these like center rooms here, it will shoot down like 99% of those missiles. But for these outer rooms, like especially these, like the shields and the weapons, like it's only gonna shoot like half of them. Maybe a little bit more than half, but not a whole lot. So it's pretty. So it's really not that great of a system to get. You're much better off getting cloaking, so that way you can actually get guaranteed missile evasion. What's up, Talkman? How's it going? Talkman Sicker FTL. Yeah, it's not necessarily wrong to get drone control here, but, you know, we could actually use a couple of fuel here, and we're going to get a couple of repairs as well. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and slam jam some drone control here. It's not super great, like I said, but it's not the end of the world for sure. So, and it should give us some longevity against ships that are kind of tough to fight. And we just don't have any really good weapons that we want to be using with this ship. And we're still just kind of stuck with this base setup. And we want to save scrap as best we can from now on to make sure that we can, you know, fight ship, have money for weapons to purchase. Because we're basically looking for about anything at this point, so... So we got a pirate ship laying in wait in this asteroid field. They have a basic laser and a mini beam. They do have door control, but that's not super relevant here. We are going to board them right away. And they are upgraded, by the way. Their doors are actually upgraded. So I certainly want to have a guy manning shields here. That's super important. And we're going to go ahead and board their engines immediately. And their pilot will come down here and fight us. And we want to get them dead as soon as we can. Now, if their shields are down, I'm just going to fire this basic laser. Yeah, I'm going to fire the basic laser into their weapons, so that way we can take down one of their weapons, greatly reducing the chance that we take damage here. I'm also going to up my evasion on my pulling my oxygen here. And so we kill their crew super quick. They had a human and a rockman, no big deal. 23 scrap, one missile and a drone part. So a thing that could have been really bad in this fight is if they had two Mantis, right? That would have been pretty bad. They probably would have... We could have risked losing a crew member. But in this case, we didn't get unlucky, I guess, for that. But we could have made it work. What we would have probably done in that case is when that asteroid hit down their shields, we would have actually used the basic laser to target down their doors. And if that missed their doors, then we would have used a small bomb to take down their doors. So that way we could run our crew around until we could teleport it back onto my ship or send more crew over to their ship. So. It's going good, Tuckman. How are you doing today? We had some problems at the beginning of the stream getting everything set up, but everything seems to be rocking and rolling here pretty good, so pretty happy. Having some Windows 10 problems, you know. It's just life. I'm going to go ahead and jump here. It's going to show us two beacons we haven't seen yet, I guess. Actually, it's only going to show us one, because we know this is a quest. It may or may not be a store. Maybe it's better to jump up here. I don't know. Nah, we're going to jump here first. We'll probably go to the quest next, though. Alright, so we got an AI ship here. And they have a small missile, they have hacking, and they have a ion Blast 1. Depending on what they hack here, this might be a little bit annoying, but I'll go ahead and up my evasion here. Time to downgrade to Windows 95. Hell yeah. Alright, so we're going to be small bombing down their shields here, and then we'll be using the basic laser to take down their setup. Alright, what do they got here? I think it's a one damage missile. Indeed it is, and it looks like it's going right from our shields. Alright, we'll just go ahead and have the Mantis go repair that. Why not? What's up, XCOM? How's it going, man? Go, and then we'll go ahead and use the basic laser to shoot down the weapons. In this case, we took down their ion blast, the thing that really didn't matter, but whatever. Can we dodge that, please? Jesus Christ, leave the Mantis alone! This guy's a dick! If you mind control an enemy on your ship on a 1 damage level 2 teleporter, so the enemy starts repairing it, jump away, mind control him again, the teleporter is still repairing, then teleported to another enemy ship. What happens to the stranger on the enemy ship? And my control ends. I have no fucking idea, Abel. I'm not a wizard. I can tell Nightbot's not here because I don't think Nightbot's here anyway because he posted that. No, I think he actually is here. No, I guess I must have changed the settings on him. Yeah, no, you're good. I thought for sure. That's like that's a pretty specific question. That's oddly specific, you know. I know that if you mind control an enemy, you can teleport them onto your ship. But if you mind control an enemy on your ship on a 1 damage level to teleporter, so he's repairing it, jump away, mind control him again on the teleporter, then my I don't know. I have no fucking idea. Yeah, I got no clue. I got nothing. Nothing at all. Alright, now I don't want to run my guys into the med bay, because then they'll get melted, right? This thing might fire before we take it down, which would be a little annoying, but... Ooh, yeah, it was really close. Had to be really close, but that's alright. So this is kind of the problem with having this fucking shitty weapon set up, is we can't take down their stuff really fast. Very, very slow. I could have used a small bomb to hit that, but... That's alright. Okie dokie. And last shots, might as well just go ahead and take out their weapons if we can. And they're dead. Yeah, you're dead. Put that down, put the med bay up, 15 scrap, 1 missile, and a drone part. And we're gonna hop over to the quest here. They may or may not have any, there may or may not actually be a store there, or it might be a trap, we don't know. I think he said he just wanted to go to a station. I can't remember if he said he wanted to. I don't know. Sometimes it depends on the quest. But I think we're going to be hopping over there. Looks like we got 6 jumps for it. We got to go into the exit. Did you almost lose your crew because you had them in camping in the medbay? That's like Advanced Edition 101. No, I didn't have them in the medbay. I put them in the medbay after I destroyed their ship. Just now. Yeah, you definitely don't want to have your crew. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Nah, I can't do that. This is going to be cover. I got 2 jumps. I'm actually going to do like this. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. Here. Here and then the exit, I guess. I don't know. It's kind of a weird sector layout. I do want to try and get as many jumps out of the sector as I can. It's very important. Okay, well, they have a mini beam and they have a burst laser too, so it's not too bad of a weapon setup, but there's a chance we take some damage here. That's all right. They did hack my engines, by the way. I didn't actually read the thing very closely, but they're hacking our engines. They do have doors, but they're not upgraded, and we're just gonna board them in their engines. They're only gonna have 2 crew here, and we're trying to just kill them as fast as we can. The reason we don't fight them in their piloting is that we don't want them to, you know, have a guy in anywhere, like, or either piloting so that they get that manning, the evasion bonus of him being in there. So this fires at 12 seconds, this also fires at 12 seconds, this fires 3 shots at 12 seconds, so. So your medbay was hacked, so yeah. Oh, no, I don't think so. Alright, best of luck, Opam. You have my best wishes, my friend. Good luck on finals, sir. I think at this point, like, we're going to kill their crew before they get a second volley with this burst laser too. And I can't stop them from firing the damn thing, so... I guess we're just going to potentially take 1 damage here. So this mini beam fires at the exact same time as the burst laser too. So, like, by the time, it's like, see, the shots are just about to hit our shields. And the mini beam's already done firing, right? So, doesn't matter. So we only have a 10% chance to evade any of these shots, so we're probably not going to evade any of them, but that's okay. Not a big deal. We take 1 point of damage, we get a crew kill, get 18 scrap and 2 fuel. Very nice. Get you guys in the med bay. Yeah, I'll be here, Copam. I'll be here at 8. Absolutely. Yeah, we're going to be switching games after this FTL run, but I'm sure this FTL run is going to take quite a long time. We're not even out of Sector 2 yet. We're already almost 2 hours into the stream, so I'll probably hate FTL by the time we're done with the run. So I'm not going to be doing two runs. Okay. Back into the weapon setup, and I'm just gonna go ahead and jump away while he's on his way. And Ooh, man, I really want to hit that distress, though. But this is like a complete dead end. But if I jump to the distress and then the quest, this beacon's going to be covered. So that's not worth it at all. So we're going to jump to the quest. Going to skip the distress. 20 scrap, 2 missiles, and a drone part. Nice. That's a pretty solid little reward there. I'll hop over here. You always hate FTL after Mantis A run because I always lose. Well, we're not. I don't expect to lose ever, but I just mean that I've you know, I mean, these runs take a really, really long time, so I certainly have played the game enough to know my way around it and not have to really kind of see the end from a pretty early point. But I certainly can't play FTL 10 hours a day like I used to. So they have a heavy laser and they have a small missile. And because we're in an asteroid field, we're still going to leave our shields at level 2. They do have a teleporter and they have a clone base. This is certainly a pretty annoying little ship that they got going on here. We only have one achievement. Well, technically we have 2 achievements left. One of them is destroying 15 rock ships with the Crystal A. And the other one is getting to Sector 5 without using an offensive drone, teleporting your weapons. So coming in for my pacifism run. I'm going to be boarding their shields right off the bat. That should stop them from boarding us at all, to be honest. I'm pretty sure anyway. Yeah, alright. That's good. They have a Rockman and a human here. To be honest, it's a little bit risky to actually go for a crew kill in this kind of a situation because there's a lot of, like, variables when you're fighting a... a ship in a... asteroid field, but no, we don't reset. Is there fire in there? No. Okay. I don't know. I can't hear very well. So we took out their clone bay while their shield went down, and I don't want those missiles to fire again. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take out the weapons there. All right, very nice. We killed the Rockman. We're all good here. Put our power back in our oxygen. We get 18 scrap, 1 missile, and a drone part. I'm just saying, I never go in on a run and plan to lose, and that's kind of the reason that I'm not really interested in doing that pacifism run, because I don't know if I can win the run after getting to Sector 5 without destroying a single ship. You know what I mean? That's really, really rough. I know, Zach. I was just saying. It's all good. So we're going to go here, and then here, and then either here or here, and then the exit from this jump. We have 124 scrap, but we're in danger zone here, right? We're in the danger zone, so we can't upgrade our ship in any fashion, even if we wanted to. Yeah, you do get a loss in your profile if you restart. So these guys want drone parts. I'm using drones not only for my defense drone, but I'm probably going to get hacking from my last system. I might get mind control. If I knew for sure right now whether or not I would have a drone control, or I mean hacking or mind control over my system, I might sell 3 drones, but for the most part, we're just going to ignore the station. Oh, we were fighting ships with missiles, and I'm not using my defense drone. I kind of forgot we fucking had it, by the way. God damn it. Oh, we're doing really great there, probably. Fuck, really awesome. Alright. Oh, man, not again. Fuck, this is the second time we've had this event. I'm not gonna do it. I don't want to lose a crew. I mean, even, like, we could manually search, and if we lose a crew, it's not the end of the world. Unless we lose an NG or the Rockman, then that really sucks. So if we only had Mantis on board or something, I might do it, but... fucking stupid. Should have upgraded my piloting. Ripping pepperonis. That's alright. So we got a store here. That's fantastic. It's not a very efficient use of the jumps in the sector, but this is the best that I can do. So, hop over the stope. To the stope. Hopefully we got some weapons here. Nope, no weapons. Son of a bitch. Alright. So we definitely want to buy fuel here. We have not been getting a whole lot of fuel this run, even though we've been getting a lot of crew kills. I think, you know, hacking is like the most powerful system in the game. That being said, I really like mind control, especially with a 2-man boarding setup. It's not an achievement, it's the opposite of an achievement. Yeah, no kidding. It's not, I really don't like it. I think I might buy mind control here. It's gonna make sure that we can fight more ships with more crew on them. Yeah, buy the backup DNA bank. Oh man, it's so good. It sucks because it's like it'll take away our scrap, so we can't upgrade weapons or anything, like, or can't buy more weapons. But I'm gonna buy mind control here. It's gonna be our last system. It's gonna work really good with our teleporter, and I'll show you a little bit more about using the mind control with teleporting here in the future. But a guy calling me from fucking Gordon Food Service. I don't work at that restaurant anymore. Sorry, Gordon Food Service. We're gonna buy it. It's our last system. Hacking is extremely powerful, especially with a 3-slot weapon setup, but we're just gonna make mind control work here. So we're gonna get all their fuel here, all three of it. We're gonna get a few repairs, and then we're gonna be pretty much good to go here. And I could buy a bar of power, but I'm gonna hold my scrap here. We're still only in Sector 2, and we already have all of the systems that we require for our ship, right? So we are in very good shape as far as that goes. It's just we don't have weapons, which really sucks. Eight scrap and a Defense Drone Mark II. Well, we're not really interested in using Defense Drone Mark II. Defense Drone Mark I is plenty good. Defense Drone II not only shoots down missiles and flak and stuff like that, but it also shoots down... Well, the Defense Drone I also shoots down incoming drones, but the Defense Drone II also targets lasers and ion shots. So, it's powerful, but it's not the same thing as a Defense Drone I. Like, people will complain about the Defense Drone II, just be like, oh, these missiles always hit me because the Defense Drone II is shooting down... is shooting down the lasers instead of the missiles. But that being said, you can't think of Defense Drone 2 like a Defense Drone 1, but better, because that's not what it is. They're just like two completely different things. The Defense Drone 2 is basically like a whole nother shield level that sometimes gets missiles too. That's like the best way to think about it, in my opinion. But for the most part, we're going to be interested in selling that, especially if we can obtain another weapon. All right, so we got NG Homeworlds here, which sounds pretty fucking great to me. Like, if we go NG Control, we get some more options on the line, but this is going to give us more civilian sector options. But NG Homeworlds, we're going to have more stores. The same amount of stores as an NG Control, but there's also the NG Homeworld quest here, which would be nice. It's a... We get a full repair off it. We get it's just a stealth ship quest is what it is. We got Steven. You're right, Beast. We got Steven. We call our Defense Drone Steven around here, in case you didn't know. Alrighty, we're going to be hippity-hopping over to this distress here, I would say. And some blue options for distresses, so we're all about hopping over there. See what we got. Alright, so we have a defense system that's gone haywire. Now, we do have a blue option here. And there's a couple of blue things you can have for blue option in this event. If you have an NG crew member, or you could have an ion weapon in your weapon slot. Otherwise, cloaking is another option there. This whole paid vacation until the new year thing. That sounds fucking awesome. That sounds kick ass. Hell yeah. Paid vacation. Fuck yeah. Watching Billy in the daytime felt weird at first. I see. Yeah, I know it's not a super doesn't really accommodate everybody very well, but like I've said before, it allows me to be the most consistent streamer that I can be. So I think that's pretty important. So we're going to remotely repair its targeting system. We get 29 scrap, 2 missiles, and 2 fuel. Very nice. And we see no stores, no distresses here. So we're just going to be continuing on here. And I guess we'll just jump here. It doesn't really matter. Do, 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 do. I saw a highlight when you have a motivational conversation with Steven. That's a pretty famous one. People really like that one. I thought it was pretty good. I can't say it was a completely original idea, but you know, it was a pretty fun one. What's up, Elvin? Elvin Cloud hosting us. Why, thank you so very much, man. Merry Christmas. Good to see you, man. How's it going, Elvin? If you guys don't know who Elvin is, Elvin Cloud is a fellow streamer, and he is a super nice guy. Lurking away. All right, Lurk. Sorry. I won't talk to you anymore. Okay, bye. Well, you guys should follow Elvin Cloud if you haven't already. He's a nice guy. I hope things are going well for you, my friend. Always good to see you. I mean it. So, our ship seems to be outfitted for combat. Care to take a bit of mercenary work? Yeah, sure, let's do it. All right, we'll see what they got. So our space dock is under assault from the rebels, although the dock is technically illegal within their laws. So it's very important for our trade. So, we'll agree to rescue the store here. So, what we'll have to do is we'll have to fight a rebel ship here. And then we'll get a reward afterwards. And then we'll get a store. So it's a pretty nice little quest. If we can make it over there, we will. All the love, brother. I appreciate the love.
Ooh, yeah, brother.
All right, we're going to be hopping over here. It's going to show us 3 beacons we haven't seen yet. And we got 69 scrap.
All right. All right.
Doom. So, simple nebula is actually filled with a good amount of debris from brutal exchange. Blah, blah, blah. Hard to determine who the combatants are without closer investigation. If we had level 2 sensors here, we would get a blue option. Long-range scanners did not give us a blue option for this particular event. Can we buy a small bomb if the store has one? Fuck. No. No. No, fuck you. No, fuck you. We're going to investigate the battlefield here. And, alright, in this case, we got 14 scrap, 2 fuel, and a drone part. Better than nothing. So we still see no fucking store here. There's gonna be a clump of stores in this sector somewhere. We're just gonna jump and be like, holy fucking shit. Holy freaking crap, Ryan. There's too many stores. I'm gonna go and jump here, and then here. I think, yeah. Just trying to uncover as many of the beacons as we can. So we got 13 scrap and a stun bomb. Is that close enough? Alright, is that close enough to the fucking stun bomb? Or the small bomb? I hope it is sound. You bastard. Alright, let's continue. As I told you, there was gonna be stores. There's gonna be a clump of them.
They travel in packs. It increases their chance of survival.
Okay. If we jump to this store and it has nothing that we want, then we'll go to the other store. Otherwise, I have no interest in going to 2 stores in a row, because we're already going to this store down here, because we already will get a reward from that as well, so. That's not a small bomb. That's fucking close enough. Son of a bitch. Alright, so now we're suddenly looking to be in a lot better position just from one store. They have a flak, which is fucking fantastic. And they have a burst laser 1, which is not, it's like pretty much the most middle of the road weapon you can possibly get. In a 3 weapon setup, it's not great, but our intention here is going to be to purchase the flak and the burst laser 1. And probably fuel. And we gotta, well, I don't know if we'll have money for fuel. We'll see. So I'm gonna be selling the defense drone 2, the stun bomb, and probably the small bomb, maybe? Flak 1, GG next ship. Yeah, pretty much. Like, we could use the basic laser or the small bomb with this setup. To be honest, like the small bomb is, like, better utility. But, like, I don't know. Like, the basic laser actually does damage to this ship. I'm going to sell these first. That's we know we're selling those. And we're going to buy the flak and the burst laser 1. I know I'm going to do that. The whole laser 1 is an okay weapon. You can use it if you have to. Would not recommend it, though. It's slow is what it is, and I mean it's great, it sounds great because it does double damage to systemless rooms, but 95% of the time you really need to be doing damage to systemed rooms because they're the ones that are dealing you damage, keeping their shields online, stuff like that. So that's pretty important. And so in order for me to have this flak, one online with the burst laser one. I'm going to need to upgrade my weapons twice. And so, like, we could use this setup, and this is, like, okay. Like, this is three shots, two shots, and one shot. So that's a six-shot setup, and we can use that through, like, Sector 5 pretty fine if we have to. But I don't know. This is okay. We have plenty of bombs. I'm not concerned with our bomb count. It's just that this doesn't really do a whole terrible lot. It's a good support weapon for boarding, though, to be fair. It's good. It's just I don't know if it's going to be right for us. Let's take a look here. So we want to spend 60 scrap to get that the weapons power online. I'm not concerned with the power.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Holy fuck. Billy's getting carried
today,
man.
We got a dollar,
man,
from Failstar. Strong people don't put others down. They lift them up and slam them on the ground for maximum damage. Thanks, Failstar, I guess. Thanks for the dollar, bud. What the fuck was that? That's... okay. Thanks for the dollar, Failstar. Thanks for keeping the full-time stream running, man.
They lift them up and they slam them down. Get them out of here.
All right. Thanks, Failstar. All right, we're gonna fucking... Let's see, what are we gonna be doing here? Needs more flak? Yeah, we definitely need more flak, but... I guess we're probably... To be honest, for right now, I think what we're gonna... We're gonna sell the basic... the small bomb. We're gonna sell the small bomb. I'm just gonna upgrade my weapons once, and we're gonna use the flak with the basic laser. And that's gonna be our plan for right now. And then I'm gonna sell the small bomb. I have so much to say when he finds flak in the store. Well, it's just a fucking amazing weapon. Look, I'm sorry. It's the most powerful second most powerful purchasable weapon in the game, aside from the Burst Laser 2. And I still prefer it over the Burst Laser 2 a lot of the times. But, anyway. And then on certain ships, we'll actually want to prefer to be using the Burst Laser 1 over the basic laser, but we'll talk, like, that's gonna be against drone ships and ships that we can't target very well with the flak. But, so we sold the small bomb, so that way we had some money for some fuel here, which we really do need. And then that's gonna be what we do for right this second. And since we don't have enough scrap to go do anything at that store, we're just gonna continue on here. And we're gonna go here. Four, let's see, how many jumps do we have before we gotta be the exit? I guess it's only six. I wish it was seven, but I don't think it is. Maybe, but... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I'm gonna jump here, and then here, and then we'll see. We got a flak addiction, that's true. Okay, what appeared to be a single damage ship is in fact two ships that have smashed together. And so basically what's happening here is the two anti-ships are getting it on. And they look locked together by the impact and can't free themselves. So we're going to have our anti-crew member. If you don't have an anti-crew member for this blue option, then don't bother. You're not going to get a reward by attempting to pry them apart. You'll probably get a ship fight and then you don't get the reward afterwards anyway. So we'll have the anti-crew member. Your anti-crew member refuses. In a halting use of adjectives and nouns followed by some animated holographic aids, the anti explains the ships are using each other to achieve a union. They're doing it. Alright, so let's go ahead and continue here. We got a repair burst, 21 scrap, 1 drone part, and 3 missiles. Okie dokie. That's great. Fucking ridiculous. Yeah, I don't think we have 6 jumps here. Maybe we do. It might be close, but I don't know.
Woohoo! Oh, Billy's getting carried today, man!
I eat my tacos over a tortilla. That way, when stuff falls out, boom, another taco. That's just poor taco consumption, Failstar. You're just not giving the taco the respect that it deserves, alright? That's like a burrito, anyway. Nope. That ain't right. That boy ain't right, I tell you what. All right. So we gotta sell this repair bomb. We'll be able to do that at that quest, though. And when that shit happens, I create another taco. Then half the time, you just have this naked tortilla shell afterwards. You know, I think we probably can hit all five of these jumps. It's really close. But I think we can. I think we're gonna say that we can. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we're gonna say that we can. I don't know for sure. A tour taco. I love the repair burst on a 4-slot ship. I do not like the repair burst in any instance, personally. Like, if you don't have anything else to do in the 4th slot, I suppose you could use it, but... So, we arrive near a small fleet of civilian energy ships. A simple decryption and translation of their comm frequency tells you that they're obviously having a frantic discussion about something obviously troubling them. Have your engine crew member contact them. So our goals have analogous elements, however, not all available for disclosure. So, offer our help. And so, these are the quests that are the cell ship quests. So, we might get one quest marker here and the other one in the next sector. But I don't know how the fuck they fit both of them here. Okay, that's where they are. So, what these quests are is they are ships where we have to fight rebel ships. And one of them has information and the other one doesn't. So, one of them will give us an additional quest. The other one will not have the information and we'll just kill them. So, we're going to go to the quest first. And I'm hoping that this exit doesn't get covered, because if it does, then fuck my life, we're going to have a pretty bad time. Nah, I think we're good, so we're going to go to the quest. We should get a rebel ship fight here, and then we'll get a shop afterwards. I don't know what kind of a reward we'll get. Okay, so they have a basic laser and a mini beam and a beam drone. So with 2 shields, they literally can't deal us damage. So, okay, let's kick some ass. So we can just take our time here. They have 2 levels of shields, but we're not even going to shoot at them. That's not what we're going to be doing here. I could shoot the basic laser on auto fire just to get some training, just for fun, but we don't need to do that. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to show you a little bit about boarding with 2-man setups here. Okay. Show you a little bit about boarding with 2-man setups and using mind control. 1 second, let me just make a note here. This could be a highlightable situation, I suppose. I got a note here about crypt rats. What the fuck? What am I doing here? I'm like out of notable paper. Okay, so again, the ship can't deal us damage, so we're not concerned with that. Fucking crypt rats. Yeah. Okay, so here's what we're going to be doing. Now, we're going to be using mind control here to take control of an enemy and use our 2-man boarding setup to make sure that we don't run the risk of taking any damage to our crew. So, we're going to pause here. We're going to board their shields. So, if we board their shields, there's nobody in here, so we know that they man their ships, enemy AI man their ships based on piloting, engines, weapons, and then 4th shield. So if they had 4 guys, they would be in this room, but they're not. So here's what we're gonna do. Now we have an enemy in the room. So we want to mind control this guy, but we want him to remain in shields because enemy AI always prioritizes shields over anything else. So if we mind control him right in this situation, he'll just get ejected out of the room is what's going to happen. Because there can't be 3 allied guys in a 2-slot room, right? So what we do is we move. Oops. Actually, I only want to move one of the mantis out of the room here. Damn it. So I'm going to move this guy out of the room. It doesn't really matter. And then we're going to mind control. And that's going to mean that this guy stays in the room, which is exactly what we want. So we mind control him. He stays in the room. Now, what this does is this gives us the freedom to run either of both of our mantis out of this room and go elsewhere. So this is really important in a lot of situations. Like if they have a med bay, if they have weapon setups that are a real big problem and we don't have a weapon setup that can get through them, stuff like that. So now we can run our mantis. Let's say, let's just fucking kill this prepare drone. Fuck it. Let's just kill this thing. Boom. It's dead. It's fucking doesn't need to, but so we can have these guys do something else. We can just sit, have them sit here and just attack their drone setup. Doesn't really matter. These guys are going to sit there and fight that guy. until the mind control runs out or until he's dead. One of the two. So now that guy's dead. Right? So now these guys are like, alright, well now we want to come fight here. And now these are all, they're already a little bit weakened, and we have two mantas versus two humans, and then we can just kill their crew really easy. And so in that time, not only did we destroy that system repair drone, but we also did a point of damage to their drones, their drone control. Now, if they didn't have a system repair drone here, we probably could have done two damage to their system beforehand. So if they had a level 2 med bay, we could have destroyed their level 2 med bay and then finished off their crew the exact same way that we did otherwise. So 20 scrap, and then we got four whole points repaired. So just got a bonus scrap, and then we got our whole repaired to full here as well. And all right, so that was so that's that. Boarding with mind control, the two-man teleporter, super powerful. Now, frequently with if you have a four-man teleporter, using a strategy like that is just going to make the fight last longer. If you have a four-slot teleporter on your ship, like you're using the Mantis B or the Crystal B, frequently using mind control is just going to make the fight last longer, because by the time the fucking mind control's done, like, you would have just killed their entire crew anyway. So that's that. So hopefully that helps. All right, so here's what we're going to be doing here. We're going to be buying some fuel. We're going to sell this repair bomb. Now, they have a hull repair drone here, but hull repair drones are extremely powerful. They're pretty much the single, like, most... they're like the one super powerful thing that can completely turn a run around. But I don't use hull repair drones. I stopped using them since we did a file reset a couple of months ago, because I have, in the last, like, 200 or so runs in FTL, I have 100% win rate with hull repair drones in my system, so I don't get them anymore because they make the game too easy for me. I would highly recommend purchasing them because they're extremely powerful. You know, they repair 3 to 5 damage to your hull upon use, and they only consume one drone part, and they're really, really good. So as long as you have excess of drone parts, you can always take good use of that. And you need to have a drone control system, obviously. So no problem, Mabel. My pleasure. All right, so what we're going to be doing here otherwise is we could buy a backup battery. It's pretty early to buy a backup battery, though, so we're not going to do that. We're going to wait. We're not going to sell anything else. We're going to buy fuel, and we are going to get another level of weapons up and another bar of power. That's going to be our plan here. So this way, what we can do is we can have this flak and our burst laser one online. Going to be a nice little powerful setup. This does leave us a little bit lacking in power here in our systems, but... we'll make it work. And, yep, we're in great shape here. Should make a hull repair drone weaker and make missiles stronger. Yeah, probably. But they're not going to be doing any of those changes, so... We're going to be hopping over to these two quests, and then we're going to be going to the exit. Alright, so... Got a rebel ship here. They have a heavy laser, they have a mini beam, they have drone control, and let's unpause and pause, see what they got. Yeah, oh, by the way, these ships always try and run away for these particular quests, so they don't have any boarding drones or anything like that. No other offensive drones, so with our level 2 shields, we're not going to be taking any kind of damage here. Alright, so we're going to be boarding here. We're going to be using the same, oh no, they do have a fucking... Alright, they have an ion intruder drone, and those things are really fucking nasty. So, I'm going to be turning off my weapons here, and I'm just going to turn on a defense drone and hope that it shoots that stupid thing down. Otherwise, with my boarding strategy here, I'm going to be using the same thing that I just did in the last fight. Okay, we're going to be letting this guy into the room, we're going to move one of our guys out, mind control here. And then I'm going to go ahead and just move both of my guys into their drone system. Come on, Steven. Nice. So, like, the ion intruder drones are pretty darn annoying because they can cause a lot of problems with your ship. In that, if they get into your shields, they'll just take down my shields completely. They do 3 points of ion damage, and it's really annoying. I don't like it. But we're going to sit here and attack their drones. Hopefully we can get their drone system down here so that he's not using his anti-boarding drone. All right, so... Nice job, Steven. Great job, Steven, shooting down them things. And same as before, this fight lasts a very short period of time because we're able to kill them really fast. There we go, very nice. Quick search of their communication log showed that the tech you were searching for never passed through this base. So we got 23 scrap, 3 fuel, and a drone part. Very good, and we'll bring you guys back. And I'm very happy that the defense drone shot down that ion intruder. It can just kind of cause like a little bit of like enough of a problem where I'm not really interested in just even dealing with it. So we'll just spend the one drone part there just to try and get rid of it. I'm gonna get another bar of power here so that we're a little bit less power hungry here. No, don't need the defense drone online. All right, there we go. And basically after one more bar of power, we're going to be very happy with our power setup. It's definitely okay with just that one extra bar, but pop over to this quest. So we know that the quest is going to be completed on this one, if as long as we have no problems killing it. It looks like we're going to not have too much of a problem here. We're going to go and continue, unpause and pause really quick. And like I said, they're going to be trying to run away. We're going to do the same things, different ship layout. But they have a heavy laser and they have a missile. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to depower one of our shields because we only need one shield, right, to have our to not take any damage from that. And we'll use a defense drone here to go ahead and get that missile out of the equation most of the time. And in this case, what I can actually do here is I can actually just mind control this guy while we're in the room since it's a 4-slot shield room. And then we could just sit here and fight. And we'll kill these two guys while this guy is helping us. And then by the time mind control's done, these two guys are going to be dead. And then we can just kill them. And I can actually fire my weapons here in this fight. So I guess take out their weapon system so we don't have to run the risk of taking any damage. And there we go. And then we just murder this guy. Very nice. And Steven actually shot down that missile, so he's just really great. So we got 27 scrap, 3 fuel, and a drone part. Once their crew is dead, you don't have to kill their crew. If you get their ship low enough, they'll tell you the information. But in this case, we want that stuff. So very nice. We get the scrap on top of getting the information that we wanted. So very nice. Get dominated. All right. So we'll get you guys healed up. Get you guys back in now. And gonna get that depowered. And boom. See, look at how close that is. I was using that sheet of paper. Like I said, there's a mod for on Steam that you can use. It's like the Rebel Fleet Advanced mod or whatever the hell it's called. But I use a sheet of paper. I just have this space marked out 6 times on a small sheet of paper. But either way, I'm going to be hopping over to the exit. And pretty good. I could get a bar of power, but I think I'll just leave it what we got. You misclicked and accidentally attacked the envoy. Don't do that. That's all I got to say to that, XCOM. Don't do that. All right, so they want drone parts. So we have 11. We're only using a defense drone. We don't have hacking. I'll sell 3 just for 12 extra scrap just because I don't think we're going to really run out of them. So Slugholm Nebula. Oh, man. That sucks, gentlemen. That stinks, man. I'm sorry to hear that. Yeah, I certainly am not interested in having any of that shenanigans around here, so I really feel for you, bud. I'm going to be seeing that on Friday morning. So, they have an engine-controlled sector here, which is what I'm probably going to be going to. They do have a Slugholm Nebula. The reasons that I'm not interested in going to the Slugholm Nebula are, like, I love slugs, and I would love to have one on my ship. But fighting slugs is a whole other sack of potatoes. Right, so we're not going to be able to see on the enemy ships ever, but I mean, we don't have sensors, so we already have that problem. Slug ships typically have a lot of slugs on them, depending on what type of ships that you're fighting. And in Sector 4, the ships really start getting more powerful, so we're going to be fighting ships that has a ton of slugs on them, and we can't mind control them, right, because they're slugs. They resist mind control, so we can't utilize our mind control at all, so it really sucks. So we're just gonna go ahead and avoid the Slugholm Nebula, and not to mention that they can hack your systems and stuff like that. They're pretty much a huge pain in the ass, so. Peanut brittle, oh my god, sounds delicious. So we arrive at NG space. Alright, there's the other part of our quest there. Now, for that part of the quest, we will be fighting a Mantis-type ship that's actually manned by Rebels. So, just FYI. Turd Crystal Light. Someone's never read Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe. Alright, so we're gonna be jumping here. It's gonna show us three beacons that we haven't seen yet. So we don't see those, there's no stores, no distresses here. Now, Sector 4 is right about the time you want to be starting to get your shields to level 3 if you can, but in this instance, like, we're in energy sector, it's going to be easier ships, and we have a fast killing setup with our boarding crew and stuff, so I think we're going to be fine. Assistance requested, danger present, imminent destruction. We're going to respond to the call. Now, this can be a trap, but either way, we're fine with whatever happens. In this case, it's actually a Mantis ship, and they're attacking some poor Engies. They do have boarding, but we're going to be fine here. We're going to be fine. I'm just going to board their weapons, I think. They might have four crew, to be honest. I'm gonna board their... Oh god, they have their doors hugely upgraded. That's a problem. That's definitely not good. Alright, so he boarded me already, so that's pretty annoying. So I'm gonna mind control... If I can, I want to mind control this NG, to be honest. Oh, he doesn't have an NG. Where the fuck's his NG? Mind control one of you. Alright, so he boarded me with one Mantis here. I'm gonna run my other Mantis up here to go have him help kill this Mantis. So hopefully we can kill him beforehand. And I want to deal damage to their door control, right? Because their fucking doors are nasty and they're hugely upgraded and I don't like them and they're stupid, basically. Okay, there we go. Now their doors are down. And they do have, I could have microed this differently, but we're in alright shape. They have one Mantis that's in their med bay. And the other Mantis is here fighting me. He's going to be running the med bay in just a second. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to fire this flak, take down the shields, and fire this burst laser one into their med bay to murderize this here Mantis. So then we run our other guys in and finish them off. 40 scrap, one fuel, and a drone part. Very nice reward. Maybe we might get a double reward here. Sometimes they want free shit. In this case, we get two fuel. Better than nothing, I suppose. Try not to kill you, Abel. It's all good. We don't really lose crew too often on here, and when we do, we don't talk about it, so we never lose crew. Alright, still no stores, still no distresses. I'm going to be hopping over here. It's going to show us four more beacons that we haven't seen yet. I think that's what we're going to do. Yeah. And then we'll clear out this part of the sector, and then we'll kind of come up here. Oh no, this does connect over here. Okay, thank God. For a second, I thought this part was just all fucking separate from stuff up here. I didn't really check out the sector layout very good when I started. I could get another bar of power here. I kind of do, but I also kind of want to get another bar of weapons so I can have this basic laser online, because my weapon setup is a little bit on the weak side. But, I could do both, but then we don't have any scrap. I'm just going to get a bar of power. I think we're in okay shape. If we fight a drone ship, then that's where we're going to kind of run into problems here, but... Alright, we got an asteroid field nearby. Short-range scanners may discover useful materials. We'll explore the asteroid field. We can fight a ship here, and we can also take 5 points of hull damage, but in this case, we get 24 scrap and two missiles. Not too bad. Alright, still no stores. Alright, that's a thing. That's kind of strange, but that's alright. So I'm trying to guesstimate how many jumps we got here. We got like 6, 7, 8, 9 about. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or something like that. Alright, that's fine. Hop this way. Let's hibbit hop on over. Alright, so we got a small ship here. They got a missile. They got a burst laser 1. They got an ion blast. Or an ion charger. So this is like 11 seconds, 9 or 10 seconds. And this is up to 3 shots at 6 seconds apiece. So, and they're hacking my engines here. Certainly a pretty annoying little thing, but that's alright. I'm just going to go ahead and board their shields here. And they surely only have 2 crew here. And they're both weak guys, so we're just going to murder them very quickly. And I will probably go ahead and... I'm not going to bother mind controlling. And I'm probably going to throw up this defense drone, so that way we don't take damage from this missile. I kind of want to wait and see if it's a 1 or 2 damage one. If it's a 1 damage one, then maybe we just say, eh, whatever, don't really matter. It is a 1 damage one. 12% evasion. I don't know, I'll throw up Steven here. See if he shoots it down. Alright, that's nice. Whatever. It's just one damage, but I'll just do it. 27 scrap and 3 fuel. Okay, reward. Not super great. Oh my god! Up my evasion. No, oh, we got hit. RIP. That fucking ion shot took down one of our shields, so then we ended up getting hit. And so sad.
That's so sad.
Alright, everybody back to your position, please. So we got 112 scrap, but I'm not gonna spend it yet. I wanna see if we can find a store here, because we would love a weapon upgrade. This is the third time we've been offered to sell drone parts. I'm not selling anymore. Not selling them. Alright, we're gonna jump down here. Come on, give me a fucking store, please. Jesus. Where are they at? Assistance requested, danger present, imminent destruction. We might be a trap. Are we foolish meat sacks today? Let's find out. Oh, we're foolish meat sacks. You receive another message from the ship, this time with a mantis at the comm log. Foolish meat sacks, he yells. Sensors indicate the ship is moving into attack and borders teleport from the station. All right. So they have hacking, they have drone control, and they have ion blast, they have a burst laser one, and they have a heavy laser. So this is a pretty aggressive little ship that they got going on here. Alright, and they have a defense drone mark too. Son of a bitch. Alright, this is a really nasty ship. Where's these borders at? Okay, I can tell you they're over here because they're trying to knock down this door. Okay, we got two mantis here. Alright, we definitely want to deal damage to their weapons because they got this pretty powerful little weapon setup they got here. This fires 8 seconds, 9 seconds, and 11 seconds. They can definitely deal us a good bit of damage if they get hits in. They're hacking my oxygen, which doesn't really matter. They do have a clone bay, by the way, which is very, very annoying. The reason that's super, super annoying is that these guys that I kill, even though they weren't starting off on their ship, they'll get them. They get them back. Okay, I'm gonna try and deal damage to their clone bay here. Oh my god, rip and pepperonis. This defense drone too is super strong at taking away my dudes here. All right, we're gonna run our dudes to the med bay. I'm gonna run you here. Have you? I'm gonna vent these enemies out. And we're gonna just—they should die. But I want to try and take out their clone bay. To be honest, I want to take out their clone bay before. All right, they're dead. I want to take out their clone bay before they get cloned, because I don't want to deal with that many fucking enemies on their ships. There we go. Okay, we took out their clone bay. Very nice. They hit my doors there. That's fine, though. Alright, so we're in okay shape. We did actually get lucky and take out that weapon, so we're in fine shape to not take damage here. We're going to get you guys over here, getting down that thing down. And they will be trying to repair, but there's nothing but mantis on their ship, right? Because it's a mantis ship that took over an NG ship. So they take forever to repair shit. Same as mine. Missing all those small bombs right now. Yeah, no kidding. That's true. I'm gonna do some more damage to their weapons just so we try and run less risk of taking damage here. Because if they get those weapons online, then we're gonna be kind of annoyed. Alright. I'm actually gonna run up here. Mind control one of you. There we go. This way we'll be able to kill him a little bit faster. There we go, very nice. So once the mind control is over, then we'll double team that guy down. You're dead. And then we get the win. 13 scrap, and we got an NG named Alex. That's not a super great reward, to be honest. Man, there are many small bomb advocates. Everybody's trying to get me to use them small bombs. Them small bomb Jews. Oh, there's no oxygen in that room. Sorry about that, bud. Didn't mean to run you through there. Healed. And who gets the NG? Looks like Booner gets the name. Sound almost got it. Booner is not already named. Very good. How you doing today, Booner, by the way? How's it going, Thio? Welcome, sir. And you're going to be going over to Shields there, Booner. There you go. And 125 scrap. There's a store. Jesus, I knew they were around somewhere. Name it Slug just to shame him. That would be enough. That would be, that wouldn't be a shame. So we got six jumps before we need to be going to the exit. That being said, I don't think we can actually get that many jumps because these jumps are going to be covered after four jumps. So we're going to go like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exit is going to be the order of jumps here, I think. Hop over to the store first because we got scrap to spend. Hopefully we get something nice. You had a job interview today, so we'll see. Cool, Booner. I hope it went well, man. Hope it went well. Oh my god, they got another flak. Holy fucking shit. Alright, well, I guess that kind of solves the problem is what we're going to be doing with our weapon setup here. So we're going to be using the flak. We're going to be using two flaks and a burst laser one, and that's just going to be our setup. Like, the halberd beam is actually a really, really, really nice weapon to have. And it would be a very good idea, to be honest, to use two flaks and a halberd beam here. Because using three flak ones is not really, I mean, if I'm not saying that we'll get that third flak one, but it's definitely possible. Using three flak ones is not really the best kind of weapon setup that you can have in a three weapon slot setup because, like, although they're very fast firing and they fire three shots, they're very inaccurate, right? So if you're fighting a drone type ship, you're going to have a lot of problems. And by problems, I mean, like, you can't accurately take out their shields or weapons or any system on any kind of a drone ship. And then there's still other ships that have poor layouts for flak firing as well. So that's not really a good idea to just go all in on flak. So I would say that there's an argument here to purchase the halberd beam and potentially not use it right away, but maybe use it later. Goodness. They do have sensors, which you're kind of actually interested in actually purchasing, to be honest, but... Maybe I should have actually gone to the quest first and then gone to the store, but to be honest, we should get another store before the exit anyway. Yeah, I would definitely say that there's a good argument for purchasing the halberd beam here. Because it's a very powerful weapon. It's a little slow, it doesn't go really well with flak, but that being said, it's extremely powerful. It's generally going to be doing a minimum 6 damage on a swipe, and up to 8 damage. And 10 damage on sun ships, even. Just we can't use it right away, and we could upgrade our weapons to just accommodate the flak one and the halberd beam if we want to. Yeah, the halberd beam is super good, especially in a three weapon slot setup. I think that's the correct thing to do. It doesn't lend itself well to us assisting with crew boarding like the burst laser one does. Like, to be honest, my a really great setup here would be a heavy laser two would be one of my favorites, because that's a really nice setup. So you know what, I'm just gonna kind of hold out for something a little bit. Like, the halberd beam is great, and it's definitely would pretty much seal up our weapon setup for the rest of the run, but I'm just not in the mood for it, to be perfectly honest, so I'm just going to pass on the halberd beam right now. And it's not because it's correct to pass on it, it's because I just don't feel like using it. Alright, so we're going to go quest, and then these two jumps here, and then the store. What's up, Dolphin, by the way? How you doing, man? What's your philosophy on Shields 3? Well, we're in Sector 4, we don't need them. We're in an NG sector. Oh, people upset about not buying the halberd beam. Sorry, guys. I'm not buying it. I'm going to be getting my shields to level 4 here soon. And I think for right now, I'm just going to go ahead and get my engines up to level 4 here. We are going to be fighting a potentially kind of nasty ship here at this quest, so I'll just get my engines up. Awful, I'm watching you. Oh, Dolphin, that's so fucking harsh. Oh, God. Man, I work so hard. I work so hard to look so pretty, and you come in here and you hassle me like that. What's up, Just FTL? It's... Alright, hangar-sized cargo ship being escorted by a number of Mantis ships. And of course, so like I said, this is a Mantis-type ship. It's going to be filled with Rebels, though. Mantis scans indicate they're manned by Rebels. It even tells you, so... So we're going to go ahead and board them right away here. They do have doors upgraded, but that's fine. We don't care. We don't care. They're going to board me with just one guy here, which makes it kind of nice. And we'll go ahead and mind control one of you guys. And I'll use... actually should be using the flak and the burst laser one here so I can target stuff more easily. I can try and get into their shields or their medbay here, but it's really not likely to happen. So I'm just going to not do that. I didn't see where this guy is. It's not in the system. Oh, he's in here. Okay. Alright, there he is. We're gonna go here. Go kill him. And this other guy did run into their med bay. Alright, so I'm gonna fire this here, and I'm gonna use the burst laser one to take down their door control. Firebomb isn't coming onto my ship. I'll go ahead and up my evasion to 27%, even though I don't have a guy in engines. And it did go into my shield. That's definitely pretty annoying. I'll have you guys go help out with that. They've added that option. Well, rip. Alright, we'll have the engine can stay there. I'll have you guys run to the medbay here really quick. Get the medbay and the oxygen back online. So this guy's gonna run to the medbay, and our Mantis will be able to kill this guy, which is very nice. And then we're gonna go ahead and fire the flak here in just a second, and then we'll fire the burst laser afterwards into their medbay. Make sure that thing goes down, end the fight as fast as we can. And the medbay did go down, it was just level 1, so that's very nice. We'll kill this guy, and run our Mantis in here. Oh my god, there's two fires in here! What are you doing, Ekman? What, are you fucking crazy? This guy's fucking nuts! This guy's fucking bananas! Okay, we did dodge that one. I had our VAD up to 27%. And at this point, I'll send everybody back to their normal rooms. Well, you're done fighting in the fire? That's alright, we'll bring the fire to you. 34 scrap, 2 missiles, and a drone part. So the Angie emerged victorious. And so this is like stealth ship quest stuff like that. So if you needed to unlock the stealth ship quest, you wanted to go to the Angie homeworlds and get this quest. Yeah, right, Just FTL. So I'll ask about the Mantis ships here. Likely deployed by Rebels to avoid breaking down aggression pact, so transmit coordinates. And we got titanium system casing, 3-pole, that we got repaired up to full. I think it repairs like up to 15 or 10 or something like that. 41 scrap, drone part, and a missile. And the titanium system augments, or casing, what it does, I'll show you here in just a second. Get you in the med bay. Alright, so they get 15% chance to negate damage when hit. And that's just system damage. Not hull damage. So it's a 50% chance that the system stays the same that it was before, and we still take the hull damage. So it's not a very good system, but it does sell for 40 scrap, which is nice. So, fuck. Gotta get back in here. Alright. Yeah, we're up to 90 scrap. Like I said, we should get a store here. Like, there's gotta be a store. It's gotta be. Oh, wait, we have. 4 jumps still? To the exit? I thought we only had 3. Oh, well, that's right. Yep. Because this is going to be covered after 2. So since we see no store here, I'm going to jump here first. And one of these has got to be a store. I'm fairly certain. So we're going to jump here. Yeah, it sells for 40 scrap. That's what its job is, basically. So we're going to hop here, see both these beacons. Hopefully they're not both stores. That would be a little bit annoying. But it's even if they are, it's fine. They have a drone ship, and they have no shields. But what we can see is that they have a burst laser too. They have an ion charger. And they have a basic... That's probably a basic laser. As you can see just a little bit. You can see on this side there's no... There's no like kind of thing poking out, and it's like, that's what that is. So we can download the ship's data stores, but we're already at the end of the sector. We know exactly what two jumps we're going to be taking next, so we're not really interested in downloading their data stores. So we're just going to take the scrap. It's not going to be much different scrap than this, even on destroying the ship, sadly, so just going to take that. Dolphin Chemist, thank you so much for hosting, man. I appreciate the support. Appreciate it. You the man. I don't care what Failstar says.
He says nasty things. I'm sorry.
Oh, the damn double store. Son of a bitch. All right, we're gonna hit both stores, then we'll go to the exits. If you guys don't know who Dolphin Chemist is, he's a streamer. He's a super consistent streamer. He's a super nice guy. Don't listen to Failstar. They got sensors here, fire suppression, hacking stun, scrap recovery arm. Nothing that we're going to be using aside from selling this. And we'll go ahead and swing by the other store. I'm not going to decide on what I'm buying or not based on this store. So we could use a little bit of fuel, but even if the only other store only has two, then I'll just put buy it out. I've been mind controlled. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and hop over to the store and then go to the exits. And hopefully the store has like an interesting weapon that we want, like a heavy laser too. Got a heavy— oh, that's not a heavy laser too, son of a bitch. Okay, well, they have long range scanners though. Oh shit. Alright, we're definitely interested in purchasing long range scanners. Pretty much the best augment in the game, super cheap. And it shows you the surrounding beacons, what events are going to be at them, whether there's a ship detected or not, and whether there's like asteroid fields or ion pulses or things like that, or solar flares. And it also gives you a lot of blue options in the game, so it's very nice, super duper powerful. I'm going to be buying that, and I'm going to go ahead and just get my shields to level 3, and I could instead buy the backup battery here, but that's alright. I knew mind control was acting up. Should have gotten hacking. Son of a bitch. We could buy the heavy laser here and replace it with the burst laser one, but that's just a— that's just because I like it. We're gonna get a couple of fuel here. Yeah, 13. Let's buy one more. Fuck it. Alright, let's get our shields level 3. And let's hibbity hop on over to the exits. I could have saved the scrap to see if we have a store coming up at the beginning of the next sector, but getting our shields level 3 is really important. Heavy laser 1 is technically better than burst laser 1, but I don't think it's better enough to bother replacing it at the loss of 25 scrap. Oh, that's why we bought him, Daichiel. How's it going, man? Oh, sensors, rather? I would have bought sensors, but we didn't have the extra scrap, sadly. Because of the war, thousands of colonists have had their supply lines disrupted and have found themselves in dire straits. So we got these rebels are bringing them stuff. Well, you know what? We're going to attack them rebels. Fuck those guys. I got a boarding drone here. I don't want to really deal with that boarding drone, to be honest. We're just going to throw up a defense drone here. With two shields, we're going to be defended against the heavy laser and the beam drone. So I'll throw up Steven here, and we'll just go ahead and board them in their shields. And we'll use the mind control, and we'll just smash these dudes' face in. Actually, what I should be doing here is actually attacking their medbay here to take that down. But I didn't do that right off the bat, so whoops. And we can also use this black stuff to shoot down their like weapons or something if we want. Not super necessary, but we'll do it anyway. So even though they didn't end up killing this guy because I ran my Mantis in too early, they're all so low on health that the Mantis can just mop it up. Just mop it up here. 32 scrap, one missile, and a drone part. So what we could do here is we could steal the civilian supplies. Or we could leave them alone. I mean, stealing civilian supplies has a chance to deal you damage. Or you can get a little bit of scrap. Or you can get nothing in the form of sweet, sweet vaccines. So, you know, we're going to steal them. Oh yeah, we got some vaccinations for a local plague. So delicious. steal it or no balls. I always steal the supplies there. I can't help it. Alright, well, I got an engine-controlled sector here. Alright, we'll take that. You deserve that, thief. Fair enough. But they're delicious, though. Uh-oh, is it sincere gratitude? Is that what's better? Alright, so you can see our long-range scanners at work here. We see that there's a ship detected here. That being said, even in NG sectors, beacons with no ships detected can actually be pretty nice little rewards. You can get free scrap and stuff from them, so we'll probably hop over here. That way we can see four beacons that we haven't seen yet. We can just uncover more of the sector as we go along. I'm probably going to get a bar of power here. Yeah, let's get a bar of power. If only we could sell them back to the population. Oh, Jesus. So we got short-range scanners made us cover useful materials here. So long-range scanners don't give us a blue option here, which sucks. But if we had sensors and they were at level 2, we'd get a blue option here. But we'll explore the asteroid field anyway. We could get a ship fight, or we could find some supplies, or we could take damage. Or nothing. That works too. So we got a store here. We got no scrap. We're not going to bother going there. We could, like, kind of do a hop over here, hit a few beacons up, and then, like, we could go, like, here, store, and then work our way through the sector, I suppose. That way we have... So this way, like, we know where a store is, so we could try and get some scrap before going there. That seems like a decent enough plan. Alright, we got a Manta ship sitting here, and they are jerk faces. They got a heavy burst laser 1, they got a heavy laser 2. That's the weapon that I want. He's got my weapon. They have door control, they have no med bay, they have no teleporter either, so it's definitely gonna attack the ship here. And this fires at 11 seconds, this fires at 13 seconds. We're actually in good shape to not take damage against this ship, but I'm gonna board here. They probably have 4 guys on their ship, to be honest. Yeah, they have a Mantis here. I'm going to mind control him. Yep. Alright. And this is actually kind of a risky fucking venture here. But what I'm going to be planning on doing here is flacking down their shields and then using the burst laser to target their doors. So that way I can run my guys around. That's the plan here. Because my guys are going to be actually pretty fucking low on health here. And we might need to actually run them away. Alright, we got, whew, that was fucking, I was getting a little concerned there for just a second. I was getting a little concerned. And, we're just barely gonna kill them, but their mind control is about to end, right? So, actually, we need to actually run our guys out of here, because they're gonna get killed. Because they're about to get 4-on-1, and that ain't cool, man. We ain't down with that. That's not good. We're not interested. We might fucking lose a crew member here, to be perfectly honest. That would be very bad if that did happen, obviously, but hopefully we don't. I think we're probably okay. Oh god. Fucking run. I'm gonna wait till they're in the Bane room here. Get them out of there. Very nice. Okay. Just barely fucking made it. We're gonna get some damage on their weapons here. Try to, but we miss. That's alright. Alright, everybody's fine. I'm gonna send these two man. No, never mind. For some reason, I thought I had a higher level med teleporter. I'm just gonna up my evasion here, try and get some evasion training. Woo! Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and try and get a point of damage on their weapons. I have to turn the auto fire off here, I don't need that. Alright, these guys are full health right about when the man. Teleporters back the board here, and at this point they're all gonna be fucking low enough health. I'm actually just gonna mind control that guy. He's probably got the most health out of all their fucking crew, and then we just do this and we just murder their faces. Trying to get a fucking damage on the doors here. All right, that's fine. They're dead anyway. GG, you're dead. Rip pepperonis. 40 scrap, 1 missile, and a drone part. Bring them back. Get healed up and let's rock and roll. We're going to try and save some scrap here for the next store, so that way we could actually either, like, p- potentially purchase a different weapon other than Burst Laser 1, and also have scrap for like sensors and other augments that we may or may not be interested in. So I'm going to try and hold scrap here as best I can. Like, a lot of times, like, even though the flak fires an extra shot than the Burst Laser 1, the Burst Laser 1 actually allows me to target down specific rooms, whereas the flak doesn't really give me that option, so. Could probably take, like, 3 jumps and then go to the store. I could go, like, 1, 2, tier, store, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, then we'd be diving on the exit. We don't really want to do that, so never mind. Okay, these guys want some fuel, and we got 9 fuel. We're going to be going to a store here in another jump or two, so we'll give them the fuel that they want. And we might get the sector map uncovered, which doesn't really matter. We might get scrap. We don't know what we're going to get here. So, in this case, we got a weapon. Unfortunately, it's swarm missiles. Not something that we're interested in using, but it's something that we could sell at the store. And we got actually another store here. So, basically, once we get to the store, if there's nothing here, then we'll go to the other store. But otherwise, we'll be content with just the one. We are definitely going to buy fuel here. We've been buying fuel pretty frequently across this run, which is kind of out of the ordinary, considering we're boarding. We really have a better chance. So, yeah, we have 80 scrap here. And I'm just going to jump to the other store without purchasing anything. There's nothing else that we're interested in here. Hop over to the stove. To the stove. Disappointing Laser 1. It's just like acceptable Laser 1 is basically what it is. And there's a weapon pre-ignite, a repair arm, stealth weapons. Nothing that we're interested in here. We're not interested in the drones. I will purchase the backup battery and a bunch of fuel here as well. But that's about it. So definitely gonna grab that. And in that case, we're just perfect on power for quite some time. And we're gonna buy all their fuel, and we're gonna be pretty happy. This is a pretty nasty little ship. Nearby pirate seems to have advanced hacking tools that try to shut down your engines. And they have a missile, they have a heavy laser, and they have a burst laser too. It's not going to be too bad. As far as the 9 seconds, as far as the 12, as far as the 9 or 10. But with the defense drone, we're going to be fine against that. And we will board them right away. And since we have the mind control here, it's a pirate-type ship. So you don't know what's going to be on there. Unless you can tell because it's all painted purple and shit. But alright, so we're going to mind control this Zoltan. Which is actually kind of a mediocre mind control. It might have been better for me to just wait on that. But that's alright. Just because he dies like really quick. Okay, they have 2 NGs on board. This is pretty easy for kill anyway. But... we're going to go ahead and throw Steven online here in just a second. Get Steven in on the action. I just wanted to wait for that heavy laser shot to come in, so that way I didn't run the risk of our defense getting shot down. But in this case, boom, Steven does a good job. Fucking takes out that their missile-type weapon. And then we'll go ahead and try and get some damage in on the weapons here. Yeah, we got another weapons down. Very nice. Not running the risk of taking any damage anymore, so take that shield down. And in this case, see, this Zoltan's going to explode for 15 points of damage. Slav is already pretty darn low on health, right? So we don't really want him to be in the room when this Zoltan dies. So I'm going to try to just have it be so he dies. Okay, so he died. So that's great. So he wasn't in the room. He took the 15 points of damage, but he had the health to spare. So we'll run the Mantis back in the room here, have him help. Oh, fuck! Oh, those bastards! 3 fuel, 32 scrap. They took out my fucking... They took out my teleporter, and they put a breach in it. Bastards. So couldn't have even brought him back. If your teleporter gets taken down... and you have all of your crew on the enemy ship, you take a life raft, basically like a shuttle over to your ship. So just FYI, Zoltans do damage on death. Yes, indeed they do. In advanced edition they do. I think if you have advanced edition off, they might not deal damage. I can't remember if they changed it for the standard edition. Do Okay, we got three jumps here. We're gonna be up in like 1, 2, 3, and then the exit, I think. And I'm just gonna continue to save scrap here. Alright, so we have a teleporter detected intruder on deck. So this is a young mantis in a charred uniform is teleported onto the deck. He begs for sanctuary from the NG and offers to serve in exchange for your protection. Oops. So we're not gonna side with the mantis and fight the NG ship because we don't need another mantis on board. We already have four. We don't need a fifth. They're not good at repairs, and we're not gonna be boarding with any additional ones, so we're just gonna agree to offer the mantis in exchange for a bounty. And it could be a trap, and in which case, like, we're gonna, if it's not a trap, we can take damage, but we'll get a good scrap reward. And if it is a trap, then the mantis teleports away, and we take hull damage, and then we fight a ship. So either way, like, it's not that big of a deal, but we're gonna agree to offer up the mantis for a bounty. Because we just want more scrap at this point. We don't need another mantis crew member. So in this case, the engine captain is delighted, and we get 49 scrap. Hooray! And sometimes he's like, he won't go away without a fight, and you take like a few points of hull damage or whatever. But in that case, not the scenario. So we got 17 scrap and a shield overcharger. The shield overcharger isn't really something that we're going to be interested in using, but we can definitely sell it. Sells for a good bit of scrap. More engine power. This is not acceptable. Oh, Starfry, you're fine. What's your britching? we definitely just always want to just put the power into the engines when we're actually getting shot, especially with the backup battery. So we don't need the power in engines until the shots are actually coming in at our face. So they do have hacking here. They have burst laser, two mini beam, and a stun ion. We're gonna board them right off the bat. They might have three crew here, but they probably only have two. Yeah, they're hacking my backup battery, it looks like. So what that's going to do is that's going to pull two power away from our ship. So I'm going to pull two power out of our ship here. You see the power go here, and watch, it's going to go away. There it goes. You can see it right off the top. So I didn't want my shields to get affected or anything, so I just did the power like that. Once the hack's done, the power will come back, and I can actually use the backup battery if I want. But in this case, we don't really care. I'm going to fire on their weapons here. So ion stunner is on the way here. We're going to back up battery and get the power going, so give us 34% evasion against that. And we did take down the burst laser too, so it didn't even get the full shot that they wanted there. So we got 4 fuel, 43 scrap, very nice reward. Super awesome. Get you guys. I think there's a fire. I can't really hear it very well because I don't have both my headphones on. I think there's a fire in here. No, there's not. No, okay. I don't know what the hell I don't know what I thought I heard. It was just a mantis murdering things. If your battery is level 2, do they take 4 power? Nope, just 2. Just 2 power. To the exit we go. We got 165 scrap. I could start spending some of it here, but all right, just got a 31 scrap, 3 fuel, and a missile. Not too bad. Let's see what the next sector is here. Oh, we got Mantis Homeworlds. Oh, we got trouble right here in River City with a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for Mantis. I don't know, just whatever. All right, we're gonna go to the Mantis Homeworlds here for sure, just because I want to do that Mantis quest. Because it's Kazakh Plethkalik, a decent chance to get it. I believe it appears on a ship detected beacon, if I'm not mistaken. Let's take a quick look here. And yep, it's a possible ship detected beacon that it appears on. And what we're going to need is we have a teleporter, so we don't need to have our sensors at a super high level. And we're going to need our med bay at level 2. And we'll go ahead and do that for the quest chance. It could be any 4 of these beacons. God damn. All right. Well, we're going to get our med bay upgraded right away. And I'm going to get a bar of power and a bar of engines, I think. Hey, man, there's always room for Kazakh Plethkalik, as far as I'm concerned. That dude is awesome like a possum. Alright, I want to get these weapons online, actually. Maybe that would have been better than spending scrap, but I think we're okay. It's going to be about time we start getting level 2 piloting as well, but we're good. It's all good. Come on, Kazakhplit. Ooh, we found him on the first jump. We got lucky. It's the legendary thief, Kazakhplethkalik. Your crew look frightened. Attempt to hail him. Yamanta's crew member steps forward. He and Kazakhplethkalik perform a weird kind of alien haka. You, meanwhile, charge the battle systems. All right, so they got a charge laser 1 here and a heavy laser 2. Oh, God, and they have a basic laser and a heavy laser 1. All right, we're going to board them right away. They don't have doors upgraded. They don't have boarding. We're going to go ahead and mind control this Mantis here. And we're going to run our guys over to the teleport or to the clone bay here. I'm going to fire on their weapons to take them down because that's a pretty nasty... it's an alien haka. It's like a... it's like a dance. Like a ritualistic dance, I think is what the haka means. They're actually going to murder this guy pretty quick, so we probably won't be able to get their... Yeah, we won't get their clone bay down all the way, but I do want to take down these weapons. I don't want to take any damage against this ship. Alright, there we go. Now we're in pretty good shape. This Mantis is going to get murdered pretty quickly, and then we should be able to take down the clone bay before that guy gets cloned. Maybe. Maybe not. Alright, we do. Very nice. So there's only one Mantis left on their ship. He's probably in their shields. There he is. And he's going to get his face smashed in, and I'm going to fire flak on my own guys for no reason. Take out the weapons. So no more life signs are detected aboard their ship. You appear to have won. Quickly teleport additional crew and check for survivors. That's what we're going to be doing here. So you find Kazakhplethkalik and is slumped in a corner and he's dying. My God. Quickly teleport him back to the med bay. Your haste has paid off and you're able to bring him back from the brink of death. When his senses return, he says, I never would have thought I would see this day, but I'm willing to devote myself and my ships to your cause. Thank you. So we got Mantis Pheromones back, and we got 55 scrap, and we got Kazakhplethkalik, and we got a quest marker. And what this quest is it will give us a random weapon, which is a very nice little bonus quest here. And there's Kazakhplethkalik. He's just mastered in all skills. Don't worry. He's just a fucking legendary badass motherfucker. So we're going to get him renamed, though. Soundhound gets to be Kazakhplethkalik there. And what are you gonna do? I could have you man shields, I guess, since that's a pretty difficult to master skill. Our piloting and engines are in the progress of being learned, but they're not quite there yet. But I don't think it's really worth it to bother replacing that. We'll just put you here, I guess, or something. The one true Mantis, indeed. Alright, there's that quest, not too far away at all. I'd like to go to that store, to be honest, but I don't know, we'll see if we can make it. Oh shit, I didn't heal my crew. Fuck! Alright, that's kind of a mistake. Alright, we got lucky we don't have a ship that we actually have to board here. And in fact, I'm not even going to bother boarding them at all, or into fighting them at all. I'm just going to take this 25 scrap. Yeah, that was definitely a mistake. You can see how much faster the Mantis move here. 25% technically, but I'm just saying, this is a noticeable difference. Yeah, I fucked up, Mike, you're right. See, we can go here, store, here. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4 quests. Yeah, we can technically do that, but then we gotta fucking loop around here. I guess I can't really go to that store, which kind of sucks. Robert Smith. Yeah, Robert Smith is a pretty cool Mantis. Yeah, you're all good, Mike. It's fine, man. I made the mistake. All right, we got an ion. Chain ion here, and we have a small missile. They do have doors upgraded. Doors, anyways. We're gonna board them here. Mind control this guy, and I'm gonna move my guys towards the weapons here.